85% of the world's working. The other 15 come out here.
If you want to crown them, then crown their ass. But they are who we thought they were. And we let them off the hook.
I'm a man. I'm 40. I'm not a kid. That's not true. So get your facts straight.
What else do you want to know?
Playoffs? We'll talk about playoffs. You kidding me? Playoffs?
We couldn't do diddly poo offensively. I'm totally embarrassed and totally ashamed. We sucked.
We talking about practice.
If you call me Chris Everett to my face one more time.
Chris?
Of course, my opinion of Kira's performance. What the f*** you think is my opinion of it?
This is the Dan Dakich Show on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Hey, 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 how are you? Welcome. It is the big show. Got a lot of news today. Got a lot of things going on today. Mostly, let's talk some Indiana basketball. Let's talk about what I have said forever. That Indiana basketball is pretty much, I don't know, what's the right word? Not a fraud, but it is, whoever coaches there, and it'll end up this way with Woodson, it just will. Whoever coaches there will absolutely end up, it won't go well. It just won't go well. It just doesn't go well. And frankly, I'm not surprised. It never does. We don't have integrity. Like we don't have integrity. We have nonsense. We have, and I get it. You know, people want to hate on me. Hate on me all you want. Look, I don't care if Mike Woodson fires anybody. It don't matter to me even a little bit. Like you don't believe a guy is your guy and you want him fired, then fire him. But do it with a little bit of integrity. Do it for reasons that you're actually kind of like, you walk like a man. All these blogger boys that think they know anything about what's going on have no idea. None. I do. And I'm not going to break confidences with people who, by the way, are not Dane Fife. I'll be full disclosure. I've not talked to Dane. I'm not going to talk to Dane until the whole thing. If he wants to talk, I am here. But I got enough people in and around Indiana basketball to know that, look, let's have a little integrity, can you? Can we? A little integrity? Can we have a little bit of, you know, when you're upset with somebody, can you meet and talk with them face-to-face instead of side-eyeing them, instead of passively aggressive, all that kind of stuff? Can we do that? That's what, it all comes around. It's Indiana basketball, so eventually it's going to go bad for Woodson. You can't name anybody it hasn't gone bad for. And people get mad at me. This isn't a shot at Mike. This is a shot at, I've been talking about this forever. I've been saying this forever. Indiana basketball, it always goes bad. It went bad for Dane, went bad for me, went bad for Knight, went bad for Patrick Knight, went back for Jimmy Thomas, went bad for Mike Davis, went bad for John Treloar, went bad for, you can't name a coach. Lou Watson, Jerry Oliver, Branch McCracken. Branch McCracken didn't want to leave. You know, that's it. And all these rumors that Dane, I saw one, Dane leaked stuff to me. Well, if Dane leaked stuff to me, then I sure didn't hear it. It must not have been me. Because everybody and their mother wants to tell me stuff about Indiana basketball. And if you know me at all, I don't want to hear any of it. I'm just telling you. And Dane had never, ever reached out to me anything. He reached out to me about a couple drills once in a while, but never about that. But I get a kick out of it. But you gotta, we haven't walked like men at Indiana. We had Samson cheating. We don't walk like men. You got a problem, you know what? You sit a guy down, you got a problem. You don't walk around at Northwestern at the shoot around and, you know, you don't blame players doing idiotic things, which, by the way, I heard from a lot of people, and none of them, again, were Dane, but that's all right. You guys, you know, believe what you want to believe. But, you know, and guys that smoke weed, guys that are out, guys that do that, and you guys all like those guys. You guys think those guys are the heroes of Indiana hoops. I've said this before. My brother actually brought this to my attention. Years ago. He's like, you know, integrity's left Indiana. He goes, it's just not there. Why does Purdue have this all in line? Why does Purdue have between the president to the athletic director to the coaching? Why do they have this all in line? Why is there always drama with Indiana basketball? Let me ask you, why? Why is there all of a sudden on a big game, you got five guys, some of whom are smoking, some of whom are out, some of who are both, whatever. Why is there Always an issue. Why is there always a thing? Why is that? Like, hey, look, Woody wants to fire somebody, fire him. Players want to go on Tinder and Bumble and, hey, great, but show up and play. Show up and play. And now you know what you're going to see because this is the Indiana way. I guarantee you, you're going to see Woody get Rab Johns. I just saw this. Woody's going to speak at Pigs.com golf outing, right? So you're going to see Rab Johns. If he hasn't already, I don't know. I don't pay attention. Or somebody from Pigs. Maybe it's Mike. Maybe it's whomever. They're going to write a hit piece on Dane Fife, make him look bad. You know what I mean? So, you know, at the end of the day, that's what you're going to see. So they're going to write an article, and they're going to leak stuff, and all these little blogger boys have been around, and they're going to, you know, they're going to do the things that they do, and that's what people do. That's just what they're going to do, and you'll see it. I remember sitting in those meetings with Knight. I go, look, I'm not doing that, Coach, because that's not true. I'm not. No, you can get mad at me and fire. Oh, you're fired. You're signing. Yeah, okay, great. I'm fired. It's awesome. So, you know, that's great. That's awesome. But there's no integrity. I'm sorry, there's not. I mean, there just isn't. You can say there is. You can act like there is. You can say there is. But, you know, I don't see it. Again, you fire whoever you want. But here's my problem. You don't put in the release. You don't bury the guy in release. I don't give a damn. I don't care if he, I don't care what he did. He's part of the IU brotherhood. And who, by the way, is more of an IU family member, Fife or Woodson? I mean, I would argue Woody showed up. If you know anything about what happened in Alaska, I think Butch Carter talked about it. Then Woody was involved there. And at the end of Woody's career, he ends up losing to Purdue. All Fife did at 20 years old or whatever he was have to stand up to a national media and defend Bob Knight and be the spokesman for Bob Knight, rally players to stay at Indiana when Knight, you guys don't may know not know this, but Knight wanted everybody to go to a junior college for a year, and then he was going to get a job. That's what he wanted. And Dane Fife, absolutely. I just got an email or a text from, I'm not going to say the guy's name unless he says it's okay, from a very prominent IU former basketball player that says, amen, that release was bull, you know what. And that's how we feel. But that's Woody's ego, and that's what you're dealing with here. That's why I say there's no integrity. There's just ego. Not the greatest people. But again, you want to fire somebody, fire them. You're the head coach. But if you have integrity, you don't bury Dane Fife to Indiana fans. I'm sorry, you just don't. No, you just don't. Now, Woody, whether he has integrity or not, that's for you to decide. I know what I think. You don't put out your big fat freaking ego and say, hey, look, it's my decision to let him go. No, you don't do that. And I don't give a damn. I mean, I get it. You know, Woody's from the James Dolan circus and all that kind of stuff. And if anybody's read on Dolan, you know, there's smear campaigns and, oh, I don't know, man, people that know people trying to, private investigators, or, you know, cell phones tapped, you know what I mean? All that kind of stuff. So maybe that's Woody's way, I guess. Maybe it is. But, you know, your big fat ego, people love you. You don't have to put out a release bearing Dane Fife. When Dane Fife, frankly, I never saw Woody one or two times when I was at Indiana for 16 years. I mean, Dane Fife has been, you know, you think about being 20-some years old, Bob Knight fired, and the microphone's in your hand. Really? And you got to explain to the world, when every person in every media outlet is crushing Bob Knight, you got to stand up like Dane did. And Dane stood up. See, that's what guys that played at Indiana, a lot of them do, but a lot of them don't understand that. They don't understand that kind of thing. I've said it for years. This isn't a first for me. I've told you. Be careful going into business with IU. Be careful. But Dane's group, 2002, man, they brought Indiana basketball back. Those guys brought it back. And it takes Mike Woodson to determine whether Dane will always be a member of the Indiana family. So I asked you, Dane didn't lose to Purdue in the NCAA tournament. I'm not talking about what you do as a human being. I'm talking about what you do at Indiana. Dane went to the championship game. Again, you want to fire him, fire him. Hell, no problem. Fire him. Do that. But do it in a way that has at least a little bit of brotherhood. Do it in a way that has at least a little bit of class. Do it in a way that doesn't show your big fat ego. I mean, you're 2-11 against the best teams in the Big Ten. You got beat by 30. My mother even said, well, Woodson ought to think about firing himself. So if that hurts your all's Indiana feelings, and if little girls and mommies and daddies and boys and daughters and sons and aunts and uncles and, you know, are going to get mad and get mad. But, you know, in my opinion, I've always said, man, Indiana fans don't like me because I actually stood up and showed integrity. I get it. I get the hate that I get on Twitter because you all don't like that. You all don't understand that. Well, most of you do. But the folks on Twitter and the folks all over that crush me are like, they don't understand integrity. They don't understand standing up. They understand, well, you know, get rid of them. Okay. That's fine. Yo, Dakich, we're glad you're gone. Okay, good. That's fine. All right. It's great. That's wonderful, man. All right. It's great. So, you know, at the end of the day, hate all you like and love all the players that stayed out late. Love all the players that smoked weed. Love all the players that broke the rules. Love all them, Indiana. That's who Indiana's become. It didn't used to be. Sure didn't used to be. Didn't. Indiana used to be like Purdue, man. You just put it on autopilot and the only drama was Bob Knight. Purdue's on autopilot. I mean, autopilot. I mean, damn. What'd Purdue do? Huh. They just whop, whop, whop. They just go play. They just got a president that has some sense, not some political clown that I had to sit through my daughter's graduation and listen to. You know, not, you get a painter in there, he hires guys, they do their work. There's no agendas, there's no silliness, there's no CNN, there's no nothing. There's no nothing. There's no drama. There's no Fox News, there's no political, there's nothing, there's no drama. You know what I mean? It's just go. And like I said, hey, man, you want to fire Dane? Then that's your prerogative. You're the head coach. You are the head coach, man. You go do what you want to do. But you can do it with a class. You can do it with empathy. You can do it understanding that a guy uprooted his family. You don't like him? Great, man. It's great. Hey, Dan, go ahead. Keep screaming, you know whatever. But so send me your emails of hate, which I've got a few. Get mad. Dan, are you still on board with Woody? Yeah, I'm good, man. I'm good. I think they're all mad at me. Like, we couldn't get Landon on all of a sudden. You know, but hey, that's all right. No, Dane Fife was not hired. Dane Fife was hired by Woodson. I mean, just stop with that. I mean, I saw all this yesterday, and I saw, if we got so many insiders around here, how come none of the insiders are actually inside? Now, Pigs, you got to understand, I guarantee you there'll be some type of hit piece. I guarantee you. You're not a man if there's not a hit piece. Charity golf outing, May 20th at the Foul Course. Guess who's the guest speaker? Mike Woodson. That's a Bob Knight move right there. There'll be a smear campaign. That's what we do. That's what Indiana does. It's what we do. Sorry. And I'm not talking about Woodson. I'm talking about Indiana. That's what Indiana does. They smear you. You leave. We're going to smear you. I wasn't tough enough. I couldn't do this. I couldn't do that. Okay. All right. Okay. You're right. But even back then, I wasn't. No, I ain't doing that. No, I'm not doing that one. No. But, you know, that's a big deal for Indiana. And Woody, you know, I'm sure he's got him well. I'm sure Rab Jones. Send me the article. I don't read it. Send the article to me if you don't mind. Dan, the size of the ego was obvious the second I heard him speak about himself in the third person. Of course. And then, you know, you win. And now, you know, I'm good. Hey, Woody, I hope he does great, man. Hope he brings in Randy Whitman. That'd be awesome. Randy Whitman in here. But you know, hey, or come back at me, get mad, get glad, get angry, get sad. It doesn't matter. I mean, you gotta deal with integrity. You gotta have some integrity. Look, I'm a bad guy. I screw things up and I get it. I do. I totally get it. I'm not saying you gotta be perfect. I'm just saying that if you're gonna fire a guy like Dane Fife, who literally was the face of the program in the darkest time. Do you know what guys like Buckner and Woodson and all these guys were doing when Dane Fife was standing up in front of everybody? They were cowering at Bob Knight's house. They were sitting at Bob Knight's house. You know what Dane Fife was doing? Dane Fife was sitting up front and talking about, hey, guess what? Saving Indiana basketball. How about that? I never saw Woody around. Maybe once or twice. Dane Fife, while he was a player, man. Leader on a national champion runner-up. Jeffries, Coverdale, Fife, Newton, Leach, Moye, Perry. Man, he was the guy. He and others, because they were good dudes, those guys led the entire transition of Indiana basketball. And again, how hard is it, right? How hard is it? How hard is it as an 18-year-old, 20-year-old, to sit in front of a national media that you know hates the person you're talking about and stand there and be strong? This guy says, bizarre how you blank on Woody. I'm not blanking on anybody. I'm telling you what is what. I get it, Indiana, you know, you little Indiana guy, little Curtis. I understand. But I'm just telling you the truth, and I get it. You guys don't want to hear it. So rip me. I'm the easiest target you got. 59-year-old white dude that doesn't play along with you guys. Let's do it. Crush me all you'd like. I'm easy. Get the daughters of the coaches. Get it. Boom, boom, boom. Darren, will you S the F up? No, not even close. No, this is my program. My program, the one I love. I was there 17 years. So there you go. But it is fascinating. It is fascinating. You'll see it. You'll see Ravi have an article. You'll see all these blogger boys that are now saying, well, we saw this. Okay, great. Yeah, you did. Indy Star insiders, where were you? I mean, we got insiders. We got 36 bloggers. Where were you? Man, you can say, where was I? I don't pay attention to that stuff. I know what happens at Indiana. I know how this story ends. I know it. But see, the only guy that ever took a job or was asked to take a job at Indiana and called me and asked me was, guess who? Key Smart. Never took the job. Because I'll be honest with you. Hey, I'll be totally honest with you. He called, sat in my living room when I was leaving. I was on Bill Mallory Boulevard, Bloomington, Indiana. Knight wanted to hire him. He said, hey, man. He always calls me Dakich. Hey, Dakich, come on over for lunch. Came over. We stayed through dinner and had a great time. Didn't take the job because I'm not going to lie to people. You lay it out there. You lay it out there and you tell them. Now, it's going to be interesting. It's going to be really, 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 really interesting how this all plays out. But you got to have integrity, man. Again, don't care. Mike Woodson wants to fire Dane Fife. That's his prerogative. You know that as an assistant coach. You know that. You know as an assistant, a head coach can get, and it's a bad job unless you can get a couple-year deal. But the truth of the matter is, you got to do it in a way, and every Indiana basketball player that isn't trying to, you know, hang on to Woody's teat and get tickets so you can sit over in the corner knows exactly what I'm saying. Every guy does. You just don't do that. You don't. I'm sorry. Now, Dan, did you know it wasn't going to work out with Woodson and Fife? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. But I did know that every single person that has coached at Indiana, it doesn't end well. And I don't know why that is. My brother brought that to my attention. It's going to get Woody. It just does. It just does. Like, I think I started out 2-0 as interim coach. I should have quit. Looking back, hey, that's great. See you later. I'm done. 2-0, I've had enough. Go take the Detroit job or something. I don't know. But I'm telling you, with every guy at Indiana, it just doesn't work out. Former player, name me one. Name me one that's gone back to Indiana and it's worked out. I guess Anthony Thompson, but that's football. I mean, you can't name one. I'm sorry, you just can't. So now, you know what? You move along. No idea. People are like, well, who are they going to hire? I got no idea. I don't have, nor do I want to have any idea. People are like, well, hope it's not Dakich. Are you insane? I would DoorDash before I'd work for those guys. What they did to Dane Fife in that release, whether it's the athletic director, who I like, Woodson, who I like, it's inexcusable. And then you got guys that are sitting there as coaches that got fired from the previous staff that haven't done jack squat for Indiana, but they made a lot of money. Kenny Hunter's made a lot of money off Indiana, man. Woo, lot of money. Smear campaign, I'm sure, has already started. I'm sure the smear campaign on Dane. If it happens, then I am going to call Dane. Then I am going to say, let's go. Who's a bigger Hoosier? Why is Mike Woodson allowed I don't know what the right word is. Well, he'll always be a member of the Indiana family, like he's Josh Smith. Dane Fife stood up. I mean, when Bob Knight, and there were fires and there were protests on campus, go back and look at it. And look at what Mike Woodson did in Alaska. Or his last college game with Isaiah and Landon and all these guys, lose to Purdue. Who's a bigger Indiana member of the family? Really? That's cool. You guys, I mean, Dane Fife, man, that dude had to show. I mean, he had to show big time. I mean, Dane Fife couldn't hide when he was in college. He had to get out. Look it up. I'm trying to find some now. Man, when Dane was in college, he had to go out in front of a hating media. I mean, a hating media. They hated Bob Knight. Hated him. You know the deal. And Knight and Dane had to explain literally to the world. Those of you that don't remember, dude, this was to the world. He had to explain it. And then he had to be tough enough, along with others, not just him. Great group of guys. I've always had so, I don't know those guys. I know Tommy. And I know Dane. I don't really know any of the rest of those guys. But he had to say to the world what the world didn't want to hear as a 20-year-old. It's the same reason I tell you that I absolutely loved, I guess. I don't know if he's playing anymore. Cam Newton. Cam Newton had every single freaking day. He had the media on him. And you know what he did? He stood the hell up. Man. And Dane, well, guess what? Dane did the same thing at 20 years old, man. And now he doesn't need Mike Woodson vouching for whether he's an Indiana guy. Hell, I think I'll have an Indiana reunion myself for real Indiana guys. Those guys, can you imagine? I'm trying to find a video. If anybody can find a video of Dane, I can still see him. I can still see him, you know, out there talking to a national media. Man, 20 years old, Hoosier Nation. Burning stuff, right? Things on fire. Things are blowing. People are in combat boots, right? Woo. Aaron Wright says, bitterness is a stinky cologne. I'm not bitter about nothing. I'm just here as a radio guy. I have a different perspective on it, so hate all you'd like. It's cool with me. But damn. I'll take some phone calls if you'd like at 317-239-1070. We can talk about this all day, obviously. I am going to talk to Rob Blackman. I cleared some space today because I want the YouTube chatters in. I want the folks that want to jump on here. If you'd like to talk, we'd love to have you. Whatever you want, we are in at 317-239-1070. We're almost at 700 people watching. Appreciate you. Let's talk about it. Dane Fife out. Is Purdue, is Indiana University, is Indiana University better off after a year with Mike Woodson than they were a year ago? I'll explain why I'm not so sure when we come back.
Whether your company is still in a basement office or expanding cross country, Uline will be there on your road to success. Visit uline.com.
Gorgeous gaming, stunning streams, unbelievable bandwidth. It's another Lifestyles of Gagillionaires. Meet the AT&T Fiber customers winning at life with hyper gig speeds. Meet Gagillionaire Terry. While his love of streaming horror movies has him constantly on the edge of his seat, his internet bill won't give him a scare.
Oh, don't go in there. I'm telling you.
Because since Terry upgraded to AT&T Fiber with hyper gig speeds, he doesn't worry about data caps or equipment fees.
Come on, man. The door's open for a reason.
And best yet, he also doesn't stress about a price increase at 12 months. Because with the amazing Gagillionaire lifestyle comes an exquisite sense of tranquility. Most of the time. Live like a Gagillionaire. Get straightforward pricing with AT&T Fiber. Internet that upgrades everything. No data caps, no equipment fees, and no price increase in 12 months.
Limited availability in select areas. Visit att.com/hypergig for details.
My friend kept complaining about car insurance.
I need affordable insurance to get back on the road. I gotta get to work.
So I played her this song.
1-800-SAY-FAUTO. Pick up the phone. The call is free.
And she was like,
play that again.
1-800-SAY-FAUTO.
Safe Auto believes everyone deserves affordable coverage. In just 3 minutes, you can save big with low down payments on state minimum coverage.
This is my jam.
Play it safe. Safe Auto.
Call 1-800-SAFE-AUTO for your quote today.
BetMGM, the king of sportsbooks, unleashes the spirit of Las Vegas with BetMGM Rewards. Every time you make a wager at BetMGM, you can earn BetMGM Rewards points that you can redeem for online bonus credits like free bets and risk-free tokens. Planning a trip to Vegas? You can also convert your BetMGM points into MGM Rewards points that you can use towards dining, shows, and hotel rooms at over 20 MGM Resorts properties located on the Las Vegas Strip and nationwide. BetMGM Rewards is sports betting's premier loyalty program, featuring exclusive offers, incredible experiences, and valuable perks when you wager on the BetMGM app. Sign up with BetMGM or log on today to get an even bigger piece of the action with BetMGM Rewards. Visit BetMGM.com for terms and conditions. Must be 21 years of age or older to wager. Indiana only. If you or someone you know has a gambling problem and wants help, call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack. Sure, you can post your job to some job board, but then all you can do is hope the right person comes along, which is why you should try ZipRecruiter for free at ZipRecruiter.com/hire. ZipRecruiter doesn't depend on candidates finding you. It finds them for you. Its powerful technology identifies people with the right experience and actively invites them to apply to your job. You get qualified candidates fast. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you what you're looking for. The needle in the haystack.
See why 4 out of 5 employers who post a job on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. ZipRecruiter, the smartest way to hire. And now you can try ZipRecruiter for free. That's right, free. At ZipRecruiter.com/hire. That's ZipRecruiter.com/hire. ZipRecruiter.com/hire.
Want your biggest possible tax refund this year? Jackson Hewitt and Walmart have an offer you won't want to miss. Your Jackson Hewitt Tax Pro will prepare your federal return for as little as $59 and no more than $179. Taxes done where you shop. Your biggest federal refund guaranteed for no more than $179. Stop by Jackson Hewitt in any participating Walmart store today, because this offer won't last. Terms apply.
Nerd.
Dreaming of adventure beyond your backyard? NerdWallet can help you compare and find the smartest credit cards to get there. Use NerdWallet to compare travel cards with bonus miles to go from working from home to relaxing far, far away. Then use NerdWallet to compare cashback cards and turn everyday purchases into a beachside cabana big enough for the whole family.
More sand for the third tower.
She's the only boss you'll be answering to this week. Nice castle. Compare your way there. Find the smartest financial products for you on NerdWallet.
Hey, Indy. Tim Pearson here, founder of Chattanooga Whiskey. Imagine if your team scored 111 points every time they played. Sounds like a fun team to watch. And a lot more W's. It also sounds like sipping on Chattanooga Whiskey 111 Cask, an unrivaled, unfiltered, barrel-forward bourbon that scores 111 points with every sip. Our bold and chocolatey expression of Tennessee High Malt is a winner, and we can't wait for you to enjoy it as much as we do. Drink Chattanooga Whiskey. Enjoy responsibly.
Spring is upon us at Sundown Gardens. Fresh shipments of nursery stock, pansies, and pottery arriving daily. 186th Street and Spring Mill Road. sundowngardens.com.
If you love listening to our shows, then you've got to follow us on our social media. You can find us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. Search 107.5 The Fan and share your opinions with us on our posts.
It's Kevin and Querry.
Fair to say Mike Woodson fired Dane Fife.
I think a big part of it was philosophical differences between which players should be playing. Younger players versus transfer upperclassmen. Jim Todd and Randy Whitman are spending a lot of time around the Indiana program helping out Mike Woodson, which is fine, except for that they're not officially on staff, and that has created tension among those that are on staff.
Kevin and Querry.
Weekday mornings at 7
on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
It was a beautiful day.
It's the Dan Dockett Show. 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Zayman, what do you got? What you got?
Hey, Double D.
Hey.
You want a perfect example of dysfunctional? It's Indiana basketball right now. They got guys that do recruiting. They got guys that are consultants. Then they got another guy. They don't know what he does. So what's going on down there?
Appreciate the phone call. I think they got a lot of guys on staff. They do. I think they got a lot of guys. There's some guys hanging around. Jim Todd's hanging around. I don't know. What do you got, Tim? Hey, Tim.
Hello.
Hey.
Thank you for taking my call. Hey, Coach, I'm just curious. Why do assistant coaches at this level generally, you know, why would a head coach get rid of them? And because I don't see it very often. It seems like a lot of times assistant coaches depart for other programs, maybe on their own accord. And then compare and contrast, how is that, you know, with Fife? I mean, is this out of the blue, or is
what's your thoughts? I don't know enough. I mean, like people are saying, well, Dane leaked stuff to me. Nobody leaked anything to me. I mean, I found out the idiots were suspended what everybody else did. I found out why from a variety of people, none of which anybody would know that I know. But, Tim, I don't. Obviously, Woodson did not feel comfortable with Dane, and whatever that means, I don't know. But I will talk to Dane at some point, and I've heard so many stupid stuff, man. Dane has made mistakes since his first week on the job. Like what? Like what? What did he do that really, you know, irritated you? I heard people say Dane doesn't like the NIL. Are you insane? Dane got nothing to do with the NIL. Dane didn't recruit. Are you crazy? You seen those other guys on that staff? Dane can recruit with anybody. I mean, ain't no problem there. I mean, what? I don't know. I mean, you tell me. Rab Johns will have it. Rab Johns will have it. Everybody thinks they know. Everybody knows. You know, if these guys are going to do an honest expose on Dane, then how about do an honest expose on why the five kids got suspended at Northwestern? Or does Woody not like that? Woody won't give you access. Woody won't come speak at the Pigs.com golf outing. Why is Woody doing that, you think? Oh, I don't know. I'm just telling you right now. Remember when Knight went to Pegues? This is all a Bob Knight playbook. Don't really address the person that you're mad at for months and then do it. Then get that smear campaign rolling. There's nobody really at the Star that has any juice with Indiana fans. So go to Pegues. That's what Knight did, remember? Knight did that with Pegues. Knight did that. His big letter was with Pegues. No, I've never spoken highly of Kenya or any of these guys. I don't speak highly of anybody. If you were with Archie, I ain't speaking highly of you. Not even a little. I don't know, but I'm not going to tell you that a staff is, that Archie had is worth a damn. But then the other guy was, I saw him as a cheerleader in the video that he had, and he was involved in that other thing. So, hey, look, I don't know. I don't pretend to. That's the beauty of me. I don't pretend to know. But the truth of the matter is Indiana's 2-11 against the best teams in the league. All of a sudden now we got, assistant coach out, guys in the transfer portal, and, oh, by the way, five guys suspended for being out in a little bit of weed. I assume it is. I don't, that's what I've been told. So, at the end of the day, good for Woody for disciplining them, guys. No doubt about it. Absolutely no doubt about it. But are you better off a year later? I mean, one thing about Archie, I'll give him credit. I don't think I saw any guys being out and getting suspended. I don't think I saw that. So, get mad at me all you like. Get the sad out on me if you must. That's cool. I mean, people have been doing it for years with Indiana basketball. I'm good with it. But, just make damn sure that you understand. I'm all in on Indiana. I guarantee you these dudes are hating me now because you're supposed to kiss. The Bob Knight way is you're supposed to kiss everybody's ass. Then if you get fired, then we're going to talk bad about you. That'll be coming. That'll be coming. Dane did that. It'll get leaked. Because one thing these guys do is these guys want access. The number one thing they want is access. That's all these guys want. It drives people crazy. We want access. Got to have access. Woody, come speak at my golf outing. Patrick Allen, that's interesting. I'm not ready to go there yet, Patrick. I don't know if I have big enough stones for that. But I think today, more than any other day, I mean, I got daughters coming at me. I got, former players, recruits. I don't think I'm going to be invited to the old reunion. Nick Papayek says, Dan wants viewers, so here we are. Nick, you don't need to come on, man. I know you're a hater. I know you guys love the new Indiana way. Lose a lot, make videos, do some stupid stuff, get suspended, and away you go. That's cool. Dan, do you think the fan base is responsible? Absolutely not. No, no, no. Gotta have integrity, man. It's gotta run right through the program. But you'll see it. The phone calls have been made. I've been in these meetings. I've totally been in these. Hey, get Rab Johns. Hey, get Pegues. What's that website? Get Pegues on it. Get. Hey, who's on the Hoosier? Who's that inside the hall guy? Yeah. Get them. I don't think Greg's been on the Woody bandwagon. I don't think so. So now I'm going to call Greg. Maybe. But I think Greg's too honest. I do. I mean, Greg doesn't like me, and obviously, but that's fine. That's cool. I mean, I don't like them either, but at least Greg has been honest. Dana, not at all, but Greg, yes. So I don't know that they can call Greg and get a hit piece on Dane. You know what I mean? Dan makes it seem like Dane was perfect. Dan seems to always be on one side of the argument, whether it comes with conflict between a person of color. Oh, okay. And interesting. Oh, a person of color. Bada bing. Here we go. There we go. Ah, Durand, I knew. I was waiting for it. It had to come. Well, I mean, somebody else just emailed me. Let's see here. Patrick Allen. Good thing Woody fired the one white guy on staff. Nothing to see here. Move along. That's from Patrick Allen. I don't know whether Patrick's white or black. Durand, good for you, man. Yeah, it's got to be racial. Of course. Absolutely. Hell yeah. Oh, you're right. Jerome Hunter did get suspended. You're right. You're right. So I guess it is better off. Oh, there you go. Look at Patrick. Look at Duran. Yeah, the old racial spin. Right. Yeah, the old racial spin. That's where this is going. And when they want to slander me, that's where they'll head. You know, Dakich is a rotten guy. He does his bikes program. He's helped a billion people not smoke. He's given more money than, you know, whatever to fly kids to Marion's championship game. But, you know, Pigs will write something. There you go. That's the one I was looking for, Durant. I knew I could count on you. I knew it. Yeah. Yeah, the old person of color thing. It can't be that, you know, well, maybe Dakich kind of talks about everybody the same. I don't know. But, you know, that would not be accurate. The old person of color. Good for you, Duran. Keep them coming, big boy. Keep them coming. That'd be freaking awesome. Just keep them coming. Dan, laugh out loud. Dan says the ex-governor of Indiana is not as not political as the president of Purdue. Problem is, he is very political. You just happen to agree. I don't know his politics, Carvin. I don't. I know this. I know when he said he was opening Purdue, and you know our friends at I'm going to go Greg Doyle. I'm not going to say their name. Our friends at the local paper here, the local Gannett paper, wrote an article saying how awful it was. I don't agree. I don't even know his I don't even know if he's a Republican or Democrat. I'll pay that, Garvin. I'm not you, man. I'm not you guys. I'm not in love with policy ideology of a party. I just tell you what I think. Oh yeah. There's a reason you didn't become the head coach at Indiana. What would that reason be, guys? What would that be? I'm just telling you, the old Bobby Knight way, man. The old Bobby Knight way is let's get it going. And let's make damn sure that we smear folks. Let's do that. All right. You want to join in the conversation? 317-239-1070. Bobby, hang in there. I'll get to you when we came back. Come back.
He is the new quarterback for your Indianapolis Colts.
Okay, we got our guy. We can worry about other stuff now.
Matt Ryan make the Colts a Super Bowl threat.
Jimmy, what are we doing?
If you're talking about it.
The Colts just got better quarterback.
Be part of an organization that has an incredible history.
We're talking about it.
Go get Matt Ryan and then draft a quarterback.
Matt Ryan, best quarterback in the division.
Your home for Indy sports. 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Dan Dakich here for Whole Wall Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing. Never forget the plumbing. When you go and flush things that aren't supposed to be flushed down the toilet, we got problems, people. What are those things? Well, Q-tips, cotton balls, hair, condoms, tampons, those kind of things. No, paper towels, come on. Don't do that. Whole Wall Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing. Go to WholeWallHeatingAndAir.com. They'll take care of you. They really will. They'll take care of you. They'll make damn sure that you are unclogged. And don't be afraid to go to them for anything, any and all of your plumbed needs. What does that mean? Well, your plumbed needs are not necessarily only the toilet. 255-4328 or WholeWallHeatingAndAir.com.
QC Kinetics provided amazing pain relief for a former professional baseball player, and you have access to the same life-changing treatments as retired Braves pitcher Jose Alvarez.
I put a lot of stress and strain and work on my right arm, but my right elbow took most of the damage with three surgeries.
Arthritis developed, and the pain was unbearable.
It wasn't just pain when I was trying to play sports. It was anytime I was moving the right elbow. It was pretty excruciating at times.
That's when Jose discovered QC Kinetics and their regenerative treatment. treatments that help the body heal itself, restoring damaged tissue and providing relief with no surgery or downtime. Jose's message to the medical professionals at QC Kinetics?
My elbow is feeling outstanding. Where were you 10 years ago, for crying out loud?
QC Kinetics is right here. Call for your complimentary consultation.
Call QC Kinetics, 463-235-7160. That's 463-235-7160. QC Kinetics, 463-235-7160.
Hey, it's Stan Dakich here for my friends at AAA. You and I both know it is pothole season, man. It is crazy out there. You hit a pothole, you get a flat tire. Some of you have got multiple flats. You got to keep your head on a swivel, and you got to go slow. Do you really want to change a flat? Really? On the side of the road, cars and trucks zooming by 75 miles an hour. You got people not paying attention on phones. I do not. So get in the club. Do yourself a favor and join AAA today. At AAA, in the club, you get a flat tire fix, dead battery fix. You run out of gas, they come. Lock your keys in the car. AAA is there 24/7, 365. To get your AAA membership, visit AAA.com or call 844-GO-AAA-GO or stop by your local AAA office. And don't forget to ask about complimentary travel planning, great insurance rates as well, home, auto, life, and more. Because you don't have to be stuck on the side of the road to get assistance from AAA.
Bowling, 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 keep them balls a-rolling. Bowling, 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 Royal Pin.
Are you looking to stay cool this summer and have fun with your family and friends? Call Royal Pin Entertainment at 465-8484 to join a summer league today. Summer leagues are fun and affordable and last only a short time. If you're going to bowl this summer, bowl at a Royal Pin Entertainment Center. Call 465-8484 or go to royalpin.com to join a league today. Grab your friends and stop in your favorite Royal Pin Entertainment Center for open play. Reserve your lanes by the hour at royalpin.com. Come bowling this summer and have the time of your life. Call 465-8484 or go to royalpin.com.
Royal Pin, bowling, bowling.
Prescription products require an online physician consultation and are only available if the physician determines a prescription is appropriate. Subscription required. See website for full details and important safety information.
When you lose your hair, you lose more than just hair. You lose your confidence. But that doesn't have to happen. Today, there are proven medical solutions to stop hair loss and, in some cases, regrow what you've lost. And now you can get them online at 4hims.com, including the very latest treatment, topical finasteride and minoxidil spray. It combines two proven hair loss treatments in the only hair loss spray of its kind, and only 4hims.com has it. No more pills, no more messy, time-consuming applications. Topical finasteride and minoxidil spray is only available by prescription, but at 4hims.com, you can connect with a medical provider online who will, if appropriate, prescribe this new spray and ship it to your home. It's that easy. Get the old hair back. Get the old you back at 4hims.com. For a free online consultation, go to 4hims.com/care. Regrow your hair in 3 to 6 months at forhims.com/care. 4hims.com/care.
The Pacers head south to play the Memphis Grizzlies tonight at 7:30 on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
It's the Dan Dockett Show, 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
But I agree, it's my fault. Oh, man, all the little shavers. Dockett is a ghoul. Yes, I am a ghoul. I'm a ghoul. I'm a bad guy because I believe you should do things at Indiana with more integrity than any other school. I know you all don't agree with that. I know you all don't understand that. I know you all want Indiana to be just like another school. But, hey, look, as I've said, and I will continue to say, if you're going to fire Dane Fife, then do it with a little bit of class and empathy to a guy that moved a young family, has his parents that are getting ready to pass away. I mean, I've known forever about his mother, his father. I've known that guy for 100 years. He's battling dementia. His mother has stage 4 cancer. Do it with a little empathy. Don't act like you're. Don't be Juwan Howard. I mean, let's just understand that. Let's, you know, you ain't that. You ain't tough. No tough thing. Come on. if you were tough, you'd have conversations with people, you'd straighten things out instead of that passive-aggressive stuff that is so freaking prevalent in the Bob Knight era. Bobby, what do you say?
Coach, what's happening?
You!
I got a question. When you was the head coach, did you, as far as your assistant coaches went, did you want feedback from them during the game?
I did, but I was also one of the guys that would say, like, shut the hell up! You know, I was kind of nuts, man. I'm not the good one to go on.
But did you hate it when an assistant coach would come in the locker room after the game and possibly say, hey, coach, we should have done this. What if we'd have done this? I know, you know, I've been an assistant at the high school level for a long time, and, you know, the head coaches I've coached for, they need to basically turn around and tell me to shut up because I'm always trying to give them feedback on things. And where Dane came from, I'm just saying, at Michigan State, I mean, he was there for 7 years under a guy that's really successful. I just, you know, and then he comes to IU and he's out after one season. I just don't understand it. I just don't know if Woody's been in the NBA and they don't do that. I don't know. I mean,
I think Woody's got his guys. I think it was clear. Appreciate you, Bobby. I think it was clear Woody's got his guys, and those are noted coaches. You know, I mean, the guy, I mean, Kenya Hunter, I mean, look at that history on him, man. He's something. I mean, you know, wow. Brian Walsh, you know, you got to listen to Jim Todd, I guess. I don't know. Somebody told me that it was on Twitter, actually. Listens to Jim Todd, and I don't even know the other guy. The other guy that was the cheerleader in the video when he was mic'd up running around. So, you got to listen to all these guys, man. These guys are something. I wouldn't listen to Dane. Hell, why would you listen to Dane, man? I mean, you got a guy that, you know, has been at Duquesne. I mean, damn. How do you not listen to that? But it's more than that. It's always more than that. I don't know. You know, I know what people are saying. But, you know, here we go. Oh, that graded longtime assistant, Jeff Rabjohn's doing the work of Mike Woodson. Loyalty is among the most important commodities as a coaching staff. A head coach must know his assistants are working for him in the program 100%. Assistants telling people they're going to take over soon and the current guy won't be there long. That stuff doesn't fly. Yeah, okay. Tell the head coach you're going to land any in-state recruit that's struggling to get... Oh, Rabby's all over it. Look at Rabby. Rabby's got it going, man. Rabby's got the whole thing. Attaboy. Yeah. Telling college players what they should think politically. I think you got that backwards. Being asked to stop that. Keep politics... Oh! Oh, my God. Yeah, there you go. I didn't see that. Good for Ravi. Ravi's doing exactly what is supposed to be. You know what I mean? That's it. Oh, Troy's back. Troy was mad for a while. The reason you're not a coach, in my opinion, is you're unable to evaluate talent. Oh, okay. One example is you evaluated this team's IU team. A top 25. Okay, Troy. I mean, I always overevaluate. You're trying so hard, Troy. Yeah, I know you haven't listened. I knew you haven't listened in a year, Troy. I'm sure you haven't. Right. Hey, Dan, can you ask me a question why you did not get the Indiana job? You're not part. Well, we didn't win. And I, you know, I've had all the guys that were there like, man, I've had so many people apologize to me. But the guy running the search literally did not know a damn thing. He's a lawyer here in town. He's the old quarterback, Harry Gonzo. The old quarterback. And I got to tell you, I don't think I wanted the job. I mean, if I did, I would have had better. I walked into that interview and they're like, hey, Dan, you got to bring like a packet. I go, okay, I'll bring a packet. Okay. Yeah, I'll bring a packet. Let me get a packet. That'd be good. You know what I mean? Yeah, I'll get a packet. Okay, they're like, Harry doesn't understand basketball. He's the head of the search committee. Harry doesn't understand basketball. You bring a packet. So, you know, I'm like, I'm not bringing a packet to an idiot that doesn't understand. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? Jacob says, move the hell on with your life. Okay. I mean, I will. I moved on fine. What's everybody so mad about it for? Know-it-all, obnoxious punk of a man is what I am. I agree. I mean, look, I have a radio show. And away we go. Mike Florence says Indiana's headed in the right direction. That's good. All right. I just asked the questions. We are not headed in any direction other than, you know, to talk about this. IU fans, please, you can come at me all you'd like. Daughters, mommies, daddies, players, cousins, uncles, aunts, you all can come at me all you'd like. I had the gun kid's daddy. He was mad. Oh, Dakich. Real quick, Phil, what do you got?
Hey, Dan, so the aesthetics look awful here. They paid Archie a ton of money to get rid of him. I thought they brought in Dane Fife as the succession plan.
No, that was always nonsense. That was never the plan. That was not. That was what people said, but no, that wasn't. No.
And then, Dan, real quick, so I look at both ends of the culture spectrum. You got Villanova, extraordinary culture, IU awful. Just wanted to get your thoughts.
Oh, buddy. Absolutely. Look, I've told Andrew, look, here's what you got to do, man. Here's what you got to do. You've got to study Villanova. Seriously, you got to study Villanova. Period. That's it. You got to study him. You got to. Man, Ravi, I told you Ravi, I didn't see that. Guy just sent it to me. I knew, you know what's coming. The smear campaign is coming, baby. Ravi's out. Yeah, next Brian Snow's going to be out. All right, let's go. Crush them. Crushing souls because you got to have access. Politics were an issue. You guys have no idea. We'll be right back.
The Ride with JMV.
Honestly, I think we are all skeptical about how the Colts were going to get out of this quarterback situation. Also, Chris Ballard is just cleaning up a mess that the Colts made. This is what happened when the owner wants only 1 year from Carson Wentz. But I will say this, they made the best out of what was a messy situation. They think they can win the AFC South with Matt Ryan. We'll see.
The Ride with JMV.
Weekdays 3 to 6.
On 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Prescription products require an online physician consultation and are only available if the physician determines a prescription is appropriate. Subscription required. See website for full details and important safety information.
When you lose your hair, you lose more than just hair. You lose your confidence. But that doesn't have to happen. Today, there are proven medical solutions to stop hair loss and, in some cases, regrow what you've lost. And now you can get them online at forhims.com, including the very latest treatment, topical finasteride and minoxidil spray. It combines two proven hair loss treatments in the only hair loss spray of its kind, and only forhims.com has it. No more pills, no more messy, time-consuming applications. Topical finasteride and minoxidil spray is only available by prescription, but at forhims.com, you can connect with a medical provider online who will, if appropriate, prescribe this new spray and ship it to your home. It's that easy. Get the old hair back. Get the old you back at forhims.com. For a free online consultation, go to forhims.com/care. Regrow your hair in 3 to 6 months at forhims.com/care. forhims.com/care.
Could taxes be dragging down your portfolio? Join Edelman Financial Engines on Tuesday, March 29th at 3 p.m. or 8 p.m. Eastern for our brand new virtual event, 6 Tax Smart Investing Strategies. We'll show you why tax-efficient investing makes a big difference and how to make it part of your overall wealth management plan. Register now at planefe.com to learn about tax drag and how you can help overcome it. See how tax loss harvesting can help you offset capital gains. And find out how to make the most of tax-advantaged accounts for retirement, education, and healthcare. Register now and you'll also get a free retirement review with one of our experienced wealth planners. That's an $800 value. Join us for this special virtual event, 6 Tax Smart Investing Strategies, on Tuesday, March 29th at 3 p.m. or 8 p.m. Eastern. And you'll get a free retirement review by registering now at planefe.com. That's planefe.com. Edelman Financial Engines. From here forward.
You're always up for some fun with the family. So you order the essentials, a new board game, some baking supplies, and even a new projector for outdoor movie night. And with the Bank of America Customized Cash Rewards credit card, you can choose to earn 3% cash back on online shopping, which could increase to up to 5.25% as a preferred rewards member. Rewards which you can put toward an extra treat that everyone will enjoy, like an old-fashioned popcorn machine. Visit bankofamerica.com/more rewarding and apply now. Copyright 2021 Bank of America Corporation.
Warmer weather means more fun time outside, but it can also mean more bugs like fleas and ticks. So don't forget to help protect your pets with Frontline Plus for dogs and Frontline Plus for cats. It's easy to apply, kills fleas and ticks fast, and keeps working all month long. So you can enjoy the outdoors and your pets can get the protection they need. That's why Frontline is the number one name in flea and tick protection. Trusted for over 20 years. Find out where to buy Frontline products at frontline.com today.
Make the short trip to experience Antler Point Golf Course in Rushville, less than an hour from Indy. Give Antler Point in Rushville a swing. AntlerPointGolf.com. That's point with an E.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
WIBC HD2 W298BB. WIBC HD3 W228CX. Indianapolis.
Friday on Kevin and Query. Sweet 16 rolls on. Taking a look back at the Thursday night games. Previewing Purdue and Rake and Joe Wiz join us. Fun begins at 7. 93.5, 107.5. The Fan.
Show on 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
Hour number two. We ain't mad at nobody. The only thing I'm mad about is why not just treat Dane Fife with a little respect. And I would ask, who's more a member of the Indiana basketball family? A guy who lost last game to Purdue? Started out with what happened in Alaska? Or a guy who absolutely had to represent everything that Indiana was, get out in front of cameras, lead his team to the to the championship game. Yeah, I don't know. Nah, it's for you all to decide, you know. But I do know this, the smear campaign. Hey, James Dolan and Bob Knight are two of the best. And Woody's got it going on. Woody going to speak at the Pigs.com golf outing. Pigs guy with the smear. Ain't no surprise. It's all good. Smear. Look, I said this before, and I'll say this again. You're not a real man until you get a hit piece done on you. Seriously, you're not a real man until you get a hit piece. I'm saying. You go get a hit piece, you know, and now you're in business. Dan, this is from Jason James. Coach Woodson says I a lot. Do you think he wants I to be back? Or is he more interested in being the man? Oh, the one thing I did ask Bob Knight one time was this. I said, hey, coach, why do you always say we? Like, you never say I. There's a lot of I. A lot of I. And, you know, that's the way the world works, man. It's all good. I'm mad at nobody, but, you know, man, Dane Fife did a lot of good stuff, man. I know. He didn't, according to, you know, guys. Now, I would like to see Rab Jobs, and I'm sure he knows because he's an insider. Ask Woody, let's go through exactly what happened in Northwestern. Let's do that. Where's Kenya in all this? I don't know. I don't have the answer. But where's the other assistants in all this? Where are they at in all this? Or who brought these guys in that did? I don't know. I don't know, man. No, I'm just asking. I mean, if we're going to smear a guy that has, you know, gave everything in a toughest time ever, while, you know, all the guys were over at, you know, Digger. Digger was over there, right? Digger Phelps, he was over there. God, Isaiah, Woody. I don't know if Woody was there. Probably not. Scott, man, we got to get everybody in line. Well, guess who had to pick up the garbage of the whole Bob Knight firing thing? Guess what? The one and only Dane Fife. I'd say that Dane doesn't need one person, mostly anybody, Mike Woodson or me or anybody, to say, hey, you'll still always be a member of the Indiana family. I guess he doesn't need to do that. I bet Dane made mistakes, though. Bet she did. Of course he did. I mean, only you guys, like, right? Only the insiders don't make mistakes. Sure he did. And that's cool. Dan, doesn't seem like you're all in on Woody. I'm not all in on this. And I know Indiana basketball better than anybody you'll ever meet, which is why all those of you that don't get so mad at me. But the truth of the matter is, you know what? It never ends well. It just doesn't end well. My brother said that, man. You know, you guys actually believe for all of the stuff that the media tells you that are lies, you guys sure believe it, right? Like this Bob guy says, well, Dane was too big for his britches telling people he was going to be the next head coach while not landing a single. How do you know he did not land a single recruit? And how do you know he was telling people? And why is it the assistants, all I ever hear from guys is, I'll go in and close. So maybe Woody couldn't close on some guys. I don't know. I have no idea, but I'm just telling you the lay of the land. Maybe Woody couldn't. I mean, I get it. You guys want to believe, you want to believe what you want to believe. Like, if Bob here was a Democrat and somebody in the Republican world wrote someone, Bob wouldn't be so fast to believe it. Or if Bob was a Republican and somebody wrote it from a Democratic slant, Bob wouldn't be so fast to believe it. And it's the same thing here. This is written with Woody's. Woody made the call, I'm sure. I'm sure they all got gathered. Hey, who can we get? Rab Johns is in pocket. Let's go get Rab Johns. Hey, Woody, would you speak at our outing? Yeah, I'll speak at our outing. I got you. I'll speak at your outing. I'll do whatever you want. I'll put out some stuff. Help me out here. Get through this Dane thing. And I know how it works. Freaking Dakich. I've called all the players. I told them they better not go on Dakich's show. And that's cool, too. Uwe will come on. Man, if Uwe stops coming on, Jimmy, I don't know what the hell we're going to do. Landon, all of a sudden, he won't come on. I hope that's not true. I hope Landon will come on. Isaiah was I don't know what he was in. I'm in the airport. Oh, okay. Hope Landon comes on. Landon's my second favorite.
Dave, Crockett Radio, what
do
you want to talk about?
You know what I mean? So... anyway, 317-239-1070. Great games tonight. I can't wait. I cannot wait for these games tonight. I'm not betting against. I think Arkansas is really good, and I want Key Smart to win. But I ain't betting against. I am not betting against Gonzaga. I'm not betting the game unless I watch it and I see something. But I got to tell you, Gonzaga minus 16. Are you kidding me? Dan, maybe, this is, Brian, I can't say it 100 times, Ryan Jenkins. He says, Brian, maybe they didn't like each other. Maybe they couldn't stand each other. That's true. Hey, look, maybe they didn't, but you don't bury him in a release. You don't bury, I don't care whether you fire a guy or not. I don't care at all. If you fire, I feel bad for Dane, but if you feel the need to fire him, then you are the head coach. I was a head coach. I understand. Totally understand. But you don't bury him in a release. You have more class than that. You have more empathy. But again, that's just ego. All that is Woodson's ego. It's Woodson's ego to do the Bob Knight, James Dolan thing, to go to the smear campaign, which is what you're seeing now. And I'm here to tell you, you can smear all you want, but I'm the only one. And I'm not a great guy. I'm a bad guy. But you know what? I've seen enough Indiana University to know that, hey, there ain't a lot of integrity there. Let's put it that way. Although I do like Dolson. I do. I think he's a nice guy. Hey, remember, Pigs.com charity golf outing set for May 20th at the Foul Course. Mike Woodson's going to be the speaker. Oh, by the way, Jeff Rabjohns, who runs Pigs, Indiana Basketball. Oh, by the way, he's got a hit piece out on Dane. Really? I'm stunned by this. What do you got, Robert?
Hey, Coach, I enjoyed listening to you today.
Thank you.
What you got to say.
Thanks.
You mentioned Uwe. I just want to remind you his birthday is Saturday. You ought to try and get him on tomorrow.
His birthday is the 26th, same as my ex-wife. Thank you for the phone call. Hey, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, my father died April 8th, 2014, and you all were so great. Look, we've been through a lot of stuff together on this show. I know there's a lot of young Indiana fans that are now joining and they want to be jackasses. I get all that. That's fine. But the truth of the matter is we've been through a lot on this show. I've been divorced. My kids have been in high school through college. Man, we've done a lot on this show. But my dad, when he passed away, the show, when I came back, I can't even express to you how much that meant. Now, I don't expect all you little haters out there to understand this. So just put this away, you little haters, you know, the guys on the YouTube chats. But here's the deal. My dad's birthday is today. Bad day. March 24th, and at the end of the day, It's a sad day. It was a day that I turned the ball over against Virginia, and I was really upset about doing that in 84. I really was. But I was even more sad because it was my dad's birthday, and I thought, how cool would it be if we could win this game on my dad's birthday, right? A couple weeks, we'll celebrate, I guess, if that's what you say. We celebrate and we remember my father's passing. And, you know, but today is his birthday. He'd have been 89 years old today. Not seeing Double D smiling as much as he used to. I don't know what to tell you, man. You guys are tough. When a camera is on you every day, all day like it is, like two hours in the morning, and then now, come on. Come on. Yeesh. Boy, Pete Richardson, I'm with you. The negative IU basketball drama never ends. This is worse than a damn Cubs Billy Goat curse. Dan, the only problem you have is with the release? Yeah, I don't know why. Aren't you a human? Like, aren't you like people? Do you live in the real world? Coaches get fired, man. Jeez. Oh, man. I mean, seriously, the only problem you have, coach wants to fire you, he fires you. I'm not there every day. But if you're going to fire somebody, don't be so stupid and say, well, you'll always be a member of the family. I would argue that Woody ought to worry about whether Dane thinks that Woody's a member of the family. Doug Thrasher, I knew you'd have something good, man. Fife out. IU is back. Let's discuss 4- and 5-star recruits. Oh, man. Hey, I don't. Look, Jack, what do you got? Welcome to the show. Thanks for calling.
Yeah, Dan. Hey, one thing, just keep doing what you're doing, Dan.
I will. Thank you. Thank you.
And do you think there's any chance, and I don't, like you always say, I don't want to see anybody lose their job, but if Butler goes away from their coach, which there's rumors that they would be, or Ball State, do you think there's any possibility Dane could end up in either one of those places?
No, I don't. Ball State would have a better shot. Butler's not going to do that. I know who Butler's going to hire, and I'm not going to say if, in fact, Lavelle doesn't stay. But yeah, and I'm not one of those guys that needs to break, you know, stories. But no, they would not hire Dane there. Ball State, I think Ball State, you know, a lot of people are saying they're down to Terry Johnson and Mike Lewis. Look, I love Terry Johnson. That'd be great. I got no problem with Terry Johnson. I've always said this about Ball State. I get it. They try to overthink things. Appreciate the call. You try to overthink things, right? You're trying to, you know, be smarter. So you hire a manager from Arizona or you hire John Thompson's son. I mean, don't overthink it. You're in Indiana, man. You got Terry Johnson, who knows how to recruit, Bennett Butler, Bennett Purdue. You got Mike Lewis. Make a decision. Let's go. That's how I look at it. Doesn't mean I'm right. But I've always thought they've tried to overthink it. Well, we're going to bring in James Whitford. Okay, James is a nice kid, man. He is. Really nice kid. But you don't need to overthink these things. You got Indiana guys there. You got Terry, who's one of the best dudes ever. You got Mike Lewis, who's one of the best dudes ever. Both can coach. Both can recruit. Both have been places. Don't overthink it. Again, that's just how I look at it. Doesn't mean I'm right. Doesn't mean I'm even close to being right. Hell, I'm probably dead ass wrong. But the fact of the matter is, I don't think I am. Don't overthink it. Evansville, same thing. In fact, it's kind of weird today, Jimmy. You know what was weird today? I got a text that, hey, Dan, can you call me Walt? I said, who's this? I don't know, Walter McCarty. Jeez, world's weird. I'm smiling for you. I'm telling you, nobody has more fun than me. That I can guarantee you. Last night, you know. Who am I betting on, Jimmy? Jordan Spieth or Justin Love? Can we go through bets for tonight's games? Can we do this?
Love to.
All right. Jimmy.
Spoilers, all these picks will likely be in the plays in the day, barring something
The most important thing is to win. All right.
Let's play to win the game.
That's it. Guy said, Dan, you're miserable when IU beat Illinois. No, I was really happy. In fact, we were in the bar, and I was jumping up and down with guys in the bar. I'll try to make my every move okay for y'all. Arkansas-Gonzaga, Jimmy, it's a 9.5-point spread, over-under 154. What do you think?
if that gets to 11, which I don't think it will, I'll play it. But right now, I'm going to stay away altogether.
Gun to head. I'm going to go gun to head. And am I going to? No, I'm not going to. But gun to head, I'm not. Gun to head, I will always. I'm not betting against Gonzaga. Not doing it. Don't want to do it. Won't do it. Would you touch the over under 154? Fast-paced game. That's basically 80-75. Well, it is 80-75. It's 154 and a half.
Yeah, so. I'd play the over. Yeah.
I'm not playing the under in that.
No,
I don't know.
I hate playing over unders because people have mapped it out for me like, hey, unders, they work in these. And I'm like, oh, that works. And they're like, hey, no, overs. And then that works. I can never pick the right side. So I always stay away.
No, don't. Yeah. Not a bad move.
If you made me pick, though, yeah, over. I would go over.
This is my game. Villanova, Michigan. What side you going to?
Is it 5?
Yeah.
I lay the 5 with Nova.
Me too. Bingo. We got callers. Look at this. I am taking the 5. I think I may do a same game parlay, but same game parlays are not how I have won. They're not. I've not won with the same game parlays. I've won by making smart bets with low spreads. And I'm going to do the same thing tonight with this one. Yeah, you guys got it. My $35,000 that I was trying to win on my $100 free bet has gone by the wayside. I hit my first two, UNCW and Texas A&M, and then I lost BYU. BYU got smacked. So, yeah. Let me just also say this. The umbrella, Jimmy, over every single bet here is Purdue minus 12. That's the umbrella bet. That's the bet that says, hey, Dan, if you lose tonight, we're going to. We are 100% going to make it all up on that game. And I'm going to tell you, IU fans, why. All right? Doug Eadert, the guy with the cheesy mustache from St. Peter's. St. Peter's and Doug Eadert, well, he just got a deal with Buffalo Wild Wings. Double your bet, ladies and gentlemen. Double it. Whatever you were going to bet, double it. Oh, man, Dan, you crazy. No, okay, I'm crazy. Yes, I'm insane. It's nuts. It's crazy. It's nutty. No, double the freaking bet because all of a sudden St. Peter's goes from this nice little story to all of a sudden, oh, man, we got NIL money. Oh, okay. It's the same thing with TikTok. I don't expect any of you to understand. I don't want you to understand. You shouldn't understand. There's no way you guys should understand. Well, that's great. I've told you before, and I'll tell you again. You don't want distractions, and that's a distraction. All right, let me go to another game. Jimmy, though, that is my game. That's the game I'm going to play the most. Villanova taking on Michigan. I'll take the 5, and I may take over on it, too. Texas Tech Duke, we talked about this yesterday. I didn't get it in time. You know what it is now, Jimmy?
It's a pick'em.
Yeah. I don't think I got it in. What do you think?
I think the retirement tour extends its stay.
You do?
Going with the Blue Devils. I'm going to parlay back for one day only, the Blue Devils in Arizona. Straight up. No spreads, just straight up.
I like that. I think that was my next one. I think Arizona beats Houston. Do you remember how bad last year, and maybe you don't, and Baylor was really good. Maybe Houston's not that. But I think that Arizona's too athletic for Houston. I do. I think he's too athletic. What do you think?
Yeah, I agree with that. I mean, I'm sort of jumped on the Arizona bandwagon late in all of this. I didn't watch a ton of the Pac-12 this year, but Benedict Mathurin was phenomenal in that game against TCU. Averaged about 15. He had 30 in that game. I'm not saying he needs 30, but he is just one of many athletes that are on this Arizona team that are a reason why so many people like them as a Final Four pick to start the tournament.
I think there's a lot of money to be made.
Yep.
I do. I think there's a lot of cashola, a lot of scratch to be made over the next 2 days. I do. And I want that money, Jimmy. Jimmy, I want that damn money. You know what game I don't know, and this is tomorrow, but I was just looking at games. I don't really know. Maybe you do. Maybe you have a sense for it. I don't know. But I don't really have a sense for the UCLA-North Carolina game. I really don't. I don't have a great sense on it. I want to. I want to understand it better, but I don't have, I really don't. I don't know that game. I don't know. It's very weird.
I am riding with the team that was very good to me a year ago.
Who's that?
I'm riding with the Bruins. And also, like I told you, this is the last line of like kids I covered on the AAU circuit, Johnny Juzain, Jaime Jaquez, Tyer Campbell. I mean, just,
yeah,
I love this team. So yes, I'm betting with emotion. I'm not betting the house, but if you ask me to pick a side, that's why I'm going with UCLA.
Makes sense. Not
but North
really
Carolina
does.
Is hell of, I mean, hell of a run, and it wouldn't surprise me to see Tar Heels win. Hell, the way they dismantled Baylor, but I'm going to go UCLA.
Yeah. I am too, I think. Mike Lewis told me, he called me the other day, and we were talking. He's like, yeah, because I think we're playing really well defensively. Yeah, you know what I mean? I mean, he said that, and I don't disagree. I really don't. So, you know, I'm not sure it's going to happen. Dan, I thought about the over in the Arkansas game. Then I remembered their 28% shooting last round against New Mexico State. Fred, you're getting it backwards. Fred, they're about a 45% shooting team. That means they might have a 60% shooting team now. Maybe. Don't know. But water does find its level. You guys will believe everything. Keith Haas says, if Dane was not doing what Woody asked him to do and didn't take calls backs on recruits, that's on Dane, not Woody. Well, again, you're believing what the Mike Woodson-led media wants you to know. That's what you're believing. It's no different than politics. If you want to believe a conservative side, you believe Fox News. If you want to believe a more liberal side, you believe CNN. If you want to believe Pigs, you're believing the Indiana side. And Mike's trying to get out from under this because he understands, right? He understands that, firing Dane. Look, let's be honest. The only person going to criticize anybody around here is me. That matters. Let's be, you think those guys that want their access, you think anybody at the Star or any of these places, they're going to rip Dane? The smear campaign has begun, and it makes Woody look even dumber. It really does. It makes Woody just look shallow, small, and it's all his doing. Anything you negative you're going to read about Woody is going to come from, or Dane is going to come from Woody. You know, and that's too bad because I would hope we're above that. Aaron Stansberry, my dad would have turned 98 on St. Paddy's Day. My older brother died. Yes. Wow. Wow. Wait, who's your older brother, Aaron? Did you used to call here? Did your older brother used to call here? April 8, 2014. These similarities that I can relate to, but I'm sure with a lot of listeners, you get off track with grievances against us versus them. Talk someone in there with some good sports take. I understand you're down with Dane, but you're guilty of the very thing you accuse Woody of. You call out his integrity on air without talking to Mike first. No, I'm not. I don't need to talk to Mike. I'm not. I don't know why you guys don't understand this. If Mike wants to fire Dane Fife, it is absolutely within his prerogative. He is the head coach, but I don't think, and I don't need to talk to Mike, or I don't need to talk to anybody about this. That release is garbage. That release should make every former Indiana player pissed off, except the ones that want a job with Woody. Yeah, you want to fire him, fire him. Seriously, I mean, fire him. But that's your job. That's your prerogative. You think it's not a good fit, get rid of him. But don't leak stuff. And don't put it out there that you fired him. Put it out there that we're making a change. Dane and I have mutually agreed, and away we go. Have some freaking empathy. Don't say, hey, you know, I can see it right now because I was in those meetings. And Woody's acting you know, Jim Dolan, Bob Knight. Let's smear people. I'm just telling you. So I don't need to talk to Woody about it, Aaron. I know what I saw. What are you going to say? Well, you know, Dan, he was fired for this reason. Great, fire him. Here's why he was fired. Okay. But that release is complete garbage. And I've got more than five now, former players saying, Dan, thanks for saying that. When I read it, I thought it was crap. That was the latest one. So don't even try that with me. Seriously, don't even. I don't give a damn. You fire somebody, you fire somebody. But, jeez. Yeah, you're mad at him. Great. You're really mad at him. Great. I'm really pissed at you. I'm firing you. Well, I assume you're pissed or you wouldn't be firing him. You backstabbed me. I'm firing you. Great. All right. Fine. We're all brother. Hey, we're all family. Oh, Indiana, we're bringing the family. Oh, blah, blah. Yeah, okay. Until what? Woody gets pissed like Bob Knight? Remember when Bob Knight left? You had Buckner and all these guys. I'm not going to games. And then they would call Coach Knight and say, who was at games and all. Is that what we're going back to here at Indiana? Is that what we're doing? Hey, look, do what you do. It's fine with me. I don't care what you go back to at Indiana. I go to one game, maybe a year. I like going to a football game. I never asked for tickets. I paid my scholarship back. I feel like I paid my debt, let's put it that way, to a place that I didn't ask to go to. Hey, Dan, water finds its level. Sasha, 7.5. Oh, yeah, he's going to make 2 threes. Absolutely. I'm betting that, Fred. Absolutely. Sasha's going to be hot. He's going to be hot. He's going to hit 2 threes in the first 20 minutes. Dan, I don't think you will. I really don't think we will. He honestly has the same goals as you for Indiana. How do you know that? He's already smeared him, Jim. Jay Morris. I mean, we're already doing that. That's sad. It's just saying, look, do whatever you want. But that stuff's just sad to me. Man, when Indiana needed Dane Fife to stand up for him, though, woo! In the hardest time, woo! Was Dane there for you. Dane took, as a 20-year-old, all the arrows, baby. Shoo! 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 Stand out there, Dane. Stand out there, baby. And take them. Now, well, Woody's mad. All right. So we're going to put a release out because Woody's ego is such that I have to. Yeah, Lester. Love that guy. Remember, Lester used to call in here. Aaron, we banned you. But Lester, yeah, good dude. All right, we'll be back.
Stop by your locally owned and operated Big O Tires and save up to $100 instantly on Cooper, Nitto, and Pirelli tires. Big O Tires, the team you trust.
Hi, it's Bob from Royal Spa. Soaking in a hot tub of Epsom salts is the absolute best way to minimize everyday aches and pains. And we know all about Epsom salts at Royal Spa. Royal Spa is the only hot tub manufacturer on the market today that can safely and effectively use Epsom salts. Royal Spa hot tubs are the highest quality hot tubs on the market. Stop into any of our three Indianapolis locations today or visit us online at royalspa.com.
Ah, Royal Spa.
Could taxes be dragging down your portfolio? Join Edelman Financial Engines on Tuesday, March 29th at 3 p.m. or 8 p.m. Eastern for our brand new virtual event, 6 Tax Smart Investing Strategies. We'll show you why tax-efficient investing makes a big difference and how to make it part of your overall wealth management plan. Register now at planefe.com to learn about tax drag and how you can help overcome it. See how tax loss harvesting can help you offset capital gains. And find out how to make the most of tax-advantaged accounts for retirement, education, and healthcare. Register now and you'll also get a free retirement review with one of our experienced wealth planners. That's an $800 value. Join us for this special virtual event, 6 Tax Smart Investing Strategies, on Tuesday, March 29th at 3 p.m. or 8 p.m. Eastern. And you'll get a free retirement review by registering now at planefe.com. That's planefe.com. Edelman Financial Engines. From here forward.
Indy, finally springtime, and if you hate to paint, do what your neighbor Edwina did. She called Rhino Shield.
Over the years, I had to touch up the house. I just got to the point where I couldn't spend any more money on the outside of the house. And when I saw Rhino Shield, I thought that was the answer to my problem.
Rhino Shield's not paint. It's better.
I'd had painters here before, and it was usually quite a disaster with them leaving their equipment here and picking up things in the yard. But Rhino Shield was right on it.
Indy, now get the guaranteed protection of Rhino Shield for 15% off the regular price.
The gentleman said, if you're interested, give me a call. And I said, honestly, can you come tomorrow?
Here's Rhino Shield's Shane Smith.
This offer is limited, so call me at 888-RHINO-41. That's 888-RHINO-41.
Don't paint.
Don't vinyl.
Go Rhino.
Don't paint. Don't vinyl. Go Rhino Shield. Never paint your house again. Rhino Shield.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack. Sure, you can post your job to some job board, but then all you can do is hope the right person comes along, which is why you should try ZipRecruiter for free at ziprecruiter.com/hire. ZipRecruiter doesn't depend on candidates finding you. It finds them for you. Its powerful technology identifies people with the right experience and actively invites them to apply to your job. You get qualified candidates fast. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you what you're looking for. The needle in the haystack.
See why 4 out of 5 employers who post a job in ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. ZipRecruiter, the smartest way to hire. And now you can try ZipRecruiter for free. That's right, free. At ZipRecruiter.com/hire. That's ZipRecruiter.com/hire. ZipRecruiter.com/hire.
This spring, we're feeling bold new colors and a natural glow. Find it all during 21 Days of Beauty happening now at Ulta Beauty. Discover daily beauty steals at 50% off the must-haves from brands like Anastasia Beverly Hills and Tarte. And discover the hottest new arrivals like, drumroll please, Fenty Beauty, now at Ulta Beauty. Beauty's biggest event ends April 2nd. Shop in-store, online, or try curbside pickup today. Ulta Beauty, the possibilities are beautiful.
You could save big when you bundle your home and auto with Progressive, but when we just come out and say it, it feels like it falls a bit flat. So instead, we're going to hire a professional voice actor and pay him absurd amounts of money to say,
I like this product.
Not sure why that was better. I mean, I'm a professional too, but we didn't pay him to say the business part, so back to me. Save big when you bundle your home and auto with Progressive. Sorry, I know hearing me say it was a bit of a letdown. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Discount not available in all states or situations.
Do you feel boxed in by the pressures of running your business? With 30-plus years of HR experience, Insperity can help lighten your load. Expand your possibilities at Insperity.com.
If you love listening to our shows, then you've got to follow us on our social media. You can find us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. Search 107.5 The Fan and share your opinions with us on our posts.
He is the new quarterback for your Indianapolis Colts.
Okay, we got our guy. We can worry about other stuff now.
Does Matt Ryan make the Colts a Super Bowl threat?
Jimmy, what are we doing?
If you're talking about it.
The Colts just got better quarterback. Be part of an organization that has an incredible history.
We're talking about it.
Go get Matt Ryan and then draft a quarterback.
Matt Ryan, best quarterback in the division.
Your home for Indy sports. 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan. The Dan Dakich Show, 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Hey, Brendan, what's the name of the new Cubs guy, Suzuki?
Seiya Suzuki.
Yeah!
I actually just got off the phone with the Cubs director of hitting, Justin Stone.
Yeah?
Big fan.
He likes him.
He likes him.
What kind of hitter is he?
Right-handed power hitter, so not Kosuke Fukudome, our friend.
Man.
Not our friend Kosuke, who is a lefty, obviously. We were just talking. Kosuke Fukudome said, "What's up?" Opening day home run, and then made bank. And I'm out of here.
I think I was talking to Bob Kravitz on the phone. Now that I think about that, he was writing for the Star, and I was a head coach in Indiana. Had a big chew in. I think my brother was down there. I don't know. I think I was talking to Bob. I can't remember. But man, I remember when he hit it. It was, I think I was waiting to die. It was one of those, I was waiting to see who they were going to hire instead of me, and I was just hanging out in the office. And boom! Fukudome Yeah! Wrigley came apart.
Oh, so I bet it blew up.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm watching it. It was a cold one, you know, because
Wrigley. It was freezing. Yeah. I remember watching it after school.
Yeah, it was cold, and it was, what's the right word? Gray. You know that gray? Because before the ivy comes in.
It was all brown and gross.
That's what it is. You can't do anything about that. But I remember, who would have been the announcer? Chip Carey, maybe, huh?
No, that was Len.
That was? Yeah. 08? Really? All right.
Len took over. It's kind of hard to believe Len took over in 05. He was young when he got the job.
I was walking. We used to park on Irving Park, so you got to walk through this little... And Chip Carey, whenever he was the guy, Chip, right? Not Skip or anything.
Yeah, I think Chip left after the Bartman year.
Did he? Yeah, he was there the Bartman year. Yeah. I remember walking in, and Chip was just sitting there before the game eating lunch on the park bench 3 blocks away. He's just sitting there. Hey, Chip, you can have a good game? He goes, yeah, I think so. There we go. Oh, man. A lot of guys are crawling out of the woodwork today, fellas. I never listened to you, but I did today. Okay, all right, okay. All righty. Sit down here. Let's go through some games. Jimmy, let's go. I already told you, I'm not messing with Gonzaga. I've already told you that in my world, the game of the weekend is 1,000% Purdue. The game tonight, I'm taking Michigan. I'll give the 5. You guys like Michigan giving the 5? What are your thoughts? Anybody got thoughts? Thoughts.
Villanova's my national champion,
boys.
Villanova's, you said you weren't on the air. Say that again.
Villanova's my national champion, boys.
I guess, do you like them to win by 6?
For Michigan?
Hey, look, we don't get ahead of it. We're trying to win
money.
I don't
know, man. I don't know. If there's one thing we know from the command center.
Tell me.
You don't mess with a hot team in March.
Who's the hot team?
Michigan.
Are they really, though? They lost 2 of their last 3, including to Indiana.
Well, they're hot right now. You get some confidence.
They won
in March.
2 games. Everybody there's
who's hotter
hot.
Than them? St. Peter?
Everybody. Everybody's won. Yeah. And they lost their last game before the tournament. And they lost their last game, so they've won 2 in a row, just like St. Peter's, just like Villanova.
Yes.
Villanova's won like 10 in a row.
But there's a different level of hotness you can get from winning those 2 games.
Really?
So
wait, is one like, I don't know the young hot women, so I'm going to go old school. Is one like Raquel Welch and one like Ann Margaret? I mean, what? I don't know there's levels of hotness.
Yeah, I mean, who would be the top level of hotness? Kate Upton?
Probably, yeah.
Yeah. Right?
All right. Well, all right. Just for the sake of argument, hang on here, caller. 2, 4, 5, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 1 in their last 13. Who's the hottest girl around? That's Villanova, yeah. Pal.
All right, so take you back to last year. Who was the hottest team here? Oregon State.
Yeah.
Remember, yeah, they were hotter than anybody else.
Yeah.
I think so.
They won their tournament.
That's fair. Yeah. Right.
Michigan lost 2 in the last 3. They lost to Indy freaking Anna.
BK, I love you to death. This is a tough hill to die.
It's a tough one here. You got
so like
nothing.
2 games. You got to be right a little hotter.
I get it.
That.
I mean, I don't
2
know.
Games.
I don't know.
They beat Colorado State.
But they came out of the woodworks to win those games.
I think they have momentum.
They stumped before.
I think
yeah,
they have momentum.
Okay, fine. You
want to
say
don't
momentum?
Think like a hot.
Oh. Yeah, all right. Let's say momentum. I'm getting grilled here.
They have confidence in momentum.
I did not come in the studio to get grilled.
Yeah, you did. That's the only reason you come in here, to talk Panthers and to get grilled. Don't even try.
Yeah, the Cubs.
No, and the Cubs.
Yeah,
and Coach K.
All
right, so what's your game tonight? What game, if you're going to put DoorDash money on, what game would the DoorDash money be?
Duke.
Really? Pick 'em.
Yeah.
Wow.
What's that favored by?
Pick 'em.
It's a pick 'em game.
Pick 'em.
Wow,
it's neck and neck for my DoorDash game of Duke and Arizona. And I told Dan I'm gonna parlay them. If it's not gonna be in the plays,
so
I just
you're
pick
putting on DoorDash
games,
money.
But I mean I'm not. But he's asking me if I did.
Yeah, if you
have
did.
You signed up for DoorDash.
Yeah, I'll be honest. No, I don't. No. I don't have DoorDash money.
Tell you love it. It's really good.
unless it's football season.
Yeah, it's tremendous.
I have Pizza Hut money at best. Pizza.
That's all right.
It's okay.
Would you think about, I'm not saying you would do it, but would you think about if you had to go one way or the other, Gonzaga -9.5 against Arkansas? I don't want to bet against Gonzaga today, tomorrow.
I don't want to bet against them, but it's not like they've looked great.
No, but I got to tell you, they were tougher than hell in that Memphis game.
And second half, yeah.
Oh, yeah, second half. Yeah, first half, they looked ordinary. But I just can't bet against that. I can't bet against what I saw with no... I did not bet the game. I had no dog in the fight. If Gonzaga won, great. If Memphis won, great. But I couldn't stop watching the damn game. It was that kind of good.
If you force me to bet the spread, and I told you I would rather it be double digits, I would scoop with Musselman and hope they keep it close. I'd scoop the 9.5.
Think about just the way they performed. You would think that they're going to come out with some juice Gonzaga. I would think about maybe first half spread for them. I don't know what that is.
Yeah, I like that.
I don't know what it is.
It's usually half.
So what, like 4.5?
I don't like first half spreads in this game, and I'm going to tell you why. Here's why I wouldn't do a first half spread in this game. Arkansas, because of their way they play, because of the pressing, Gonzaga may turn it over 3 or 4 times. And were you going to take Gonzaga, or are you going to take the other
team? Well, now that I look, it's 5.5 first half spread. I don't like that.
I think I'd take Arkansas. I may take Arkansas plus 5.5 because I'm telling you, one of two things may happen. Gonzaga may boom, 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 get it down the court, lay it in against that press, and now you got to back it off. Or you're not ready for it. Next thing you know, you're down 10-4. I don't mind being up 10-4 with 5.5 in the bank with it. You know what I'm saying?
The live bet is on for me here. If Gonzaga gets down early again, then I would bet the dogs.
Yeah. And then, you know, Houston and Arizona, everybody's in love. There's a lot of love for Calvin Sampson, baby. I got to tell you, when I watched Arizona, you know what I saw? I saw some freaking athletes that play with enthusiasm, man.
When's the next time you're going to be able to get Arizona as a 1-point favorite?
Right, exactly.
That's exactly right. It's a great point. Let me go through this with you. Okay, Mr. We're hot.
I think my reasoning is fair.
Hang on, caller. Do I have a date here? Since the 26th of January, they have lost one game.
Who?
Arizona.
Yes.
One game. Now, does that qualify as momentum and hot, or do we have to win Michigan over Colorado State? And
no, I don't know. My reasoning for Michigan, they were dead.
You're saying they're dead in the water and they're right. Yeah, I get that. No, I get it. I do. But if I didn't give you a hard time, I don't know what the hell we're doing here.
No, that's fair.
I think Gonzaga's the only live bet, by the way. Like, I'm not chasing on Arizona or Duke tonight. I'm only going to chase on the Zags.
Last year taught me one thing and one thing only. Be very careful with the live bets. Purdue, Ohio State, and then the dagger. The one that went right into my chest. Texas, Abilene Christian. I fell asleep at whatever time it was, 12:30, 1 o'clock. I woke up at 4:30, 5 o'clock, sweating. Lee, I got to pay us back.
Hey, I did say, make it known, I did say on the command center last year that Abilene Christian was going to win.
Did you?
I did.
Why would you say that?
I interviewed their coach and I liked them.
I do remember this. I do remember this. I do not like that. A lot of debating right now whether Leif Garrett or Sean Cassidy were more popular. Dana Delaney, of course, for those of you that watched All My Children, you know that Alford and I would literally, after a shoot around, go back and run back to our respective hotel rooms so that we could watch All My Children. I was at the wedding. I forget whose wedding. I was also at the General Hospital wedding of Luke and Laura in the student union. We've talked about this all the time. Women were dressed, if you can believe this, in college. Women to the wedding of Luke and Laura on General Hospital. There were women on the big screen at Indiana University's union that wore wedding dresses. There were. I'm sitting there going, what? What are we doing? Adrian Barbeau, first one with, you know. Dan, with this methodology, the Pacers are on a 2-game winning streak. They are the hot team.
They are hot.
They're hot.
They are hot.
Michael is not having it.
They lost last night. Michael, what are you talking about? Lost to the Kings.
You can be hot and lose. I'm just kidding.
Did they lose to the Kings?
Yeah, thank God.
So wait a second. So Tyrese Halliburton, our new hero, his old team beat his new team, but we love what he's going to do for the new team when his old team without him is better than his new team.
That's why I didn't say anything about it.
And they didn't have Sabonis either.
Sabonis, like,
I didn't know. I can't.
Sabonis has lost his mind. He's punching people. What's he doing?
He's on like revenge tour.
He's gone right now. Crazy.
He went rogue.
All right. Well, there it is. Doug Thrasher says, I'm putting $50 on Duke, hoping I lose it. I am over the Coach K era. Do you two guys, what do you all call it? The tinfoil hats? Are you guys the conspiracy theorists and say all calls will go to K late in the game if it's necessary for K to win? Are you guys those guys?
Jimmy. Okay, let me ask you this before I answer, because you're the only coach in the room.
Yeah.
Can you, you've said before with Coach Knight, right? You can influence a whistle.
I've always prefaced this. Regular season games against non-conference teams.
But no postseason.
Postseason's tough,
man. It's like Angels in the outfield doesn't work in the playoffs.
I know that. It's not quite. It ain't quite the same in the.
No, I don't.
Well, do you guys remember?
No, I don't. I don't subscribe to it.
Do you guys remember the scene in one of the episodes of The Last Dance where Michael went up to like a ref? He's just like, "Hey, that's a foul! It's a foul!" And the ref goes, "Michael, you think that's a foul? All right."
Teed him up.
22.
Hey, I told the referee one thing one time. I go, "That was a horse bleep call." He goes, "Dan, it was like 20 seconds ago in the game. I called timeout. That was up." He goes, "I know. I got your next one." So I went in the huddle. I've told you this story before. I went in the huddle and go, Keith McLeod played for the Patriots. I go, "Hey, look." I go, "Keith, we're running, we call it shallow or something. Make a shallow cut, screener pops out." I said, "Keith, get the basketball. If you do not shoot a jump shot, take at least 4 dribbles into the basket." 2 dribbles, foul. He makes 2 free throws. We win the game. True story. And the guy's, McLeod goes, "Coach, how'd you know?" I go, I don't know.
No, everybody gets one.
I got lucky. I didn't want to tell him, you know, but I'm like, yeah, I guess this got lucky. All right, the Ohio State women's team is playing. The Indiana women's team is playing tomorrow in the Sweet 16. Saturday, excuse me. I can't wait. I'm going to watch the living hell out of that. Second grand jury. Did you see this? There is a second grand jury. I want you guys' take on this when we come back. You got time?
Yeah.
We'll take a minute. Second grand jury and Deshaun Watson are in the same sentence. That ain't good.
The Mower Shop in Fishers has all your residential and commercial mowers, outdoor power equipment, parts, products, and service also at themowershop.com and 317-849-9500.
It's Kevin and Querry.
The Colts' biggest challenge, if they're not careful, is going to be fan apathy. We are all chips in. What happens? You sit there and you go, "Well, this looks like last year and the year before."
Look at what Tennessee did. They give up a 6th-round pick for Robert Woods. The move for Amari Cooper and the move for Woods, I think that should piss Colts fans off even more. Those are deals done that the Colts should be able to execute.
Kevin and Querry.
Weekday mornings at 7
on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Ryan Kelly is the home loan expert. You can get a hold of him at 317-550-1515 or just go to thehomeloanexpert.com. And if you are a current military member or a veteran, you need to get a hold of Ryan, because Ryan, you've developed the hero loan.
You know, we wanted to do something special. And thank you for letting me jump on with you, sir. And we wanted to do something special for our military. That's why we created Hero Loan. The VA loan is one of the best benefits of being in the military. You can legit buy a home with $0. You can go buy a home with no money down. That's a great benefit, the VA loan. But the problem is, so many lenders just weren't putting the effort in. They weren't making the process easy. And that's what we've changed. At HeroLoan.com, we can close your VA loan in as little as 21 days. That's right. Close your VA loan in as little as 21 days. We'll pay for the appraisal. And then we help you with all the paperwork. If you're VA eligible, get the loan that you deserve today. Visit HeroLoan.com. That's HeroLoan.com. The only way to VA.
Dan Dakich here for my friends at Faber's Bee Window. Yeah, George Faber. Remember him? Great Purdue basketball player. Led along with Rick Mount Purdue to the Final Four, Herm Gilliam and Billy Keller. Faber Bee Windows has been caring for homes like yours since 83. More than white windows, design your home with the colors you love. Black, red, green, beige, gray, and sandstone exteriors, plus beautiful hardware options. Bee lets you virtually design colors to match the character of your home. Get up to 50% off, plus manufacturer's rebate. No interest, no payments, 24 months. Trust your home to Bee. Visit BeeWindow.com today.
Hey, Andy. Tim Piersant here, founder of Chattanooga Whiskey, the only Tennessee high malt. Try Chattanooga Whiskey 111, the unfiltered 111-proof bourbon with notes of chocolate-covered cherries and rich caramel. We hope you love it as much as we do. Drink Chattanooga Whiskey. Enjoy responsibly.
Soccer Saturday featuring Indy 11. If this is your football, this is your show. Saturday at 9 on The Fan.
Make it better. Here we go.
Dan Dakich Show, 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
A second grand jury has been convened to mull another charge against Deshaun Watson. We got the fellas in here. Jimmy and Brendan are in here. If you were right now, just that headline, if you were right now the Browns, would you have some angst about this deal that you just did?
Well, didn't they say they did their homework?
They did. They did. Do you believe they did their homework?
Well, you would anticipate that if they were going to make a trade like that, they would keep an eye out if there was anything incoming. And this is...
this is incoming.
This is incoming. So,
what do you think?
I thought I saw something, and again, what are they going to say, right? But I thought I saw something earlier from Adam Schefter saying that they said they knew about it.
Well, I would assume they would say
that. But again,
that.
What are they going to say?
Wow, this struck us right between the eyes, right? I mean, two other women didn't sue Watson. They have filed criminal charges. Watson's attorney, Rusty Harden, said on March 11th, the criminal investigations have been completed. I don't know, man. Are you surprised that somebody picked up? You guys surprised that somebody picked up Watson?
No.
Why not?
You want to go first?
I mean,
I'm not surprised by it because, and I saw, I don't know who tweeted this either, but somebody tweeted this when the trade happened. In the NFL, teams realize right now the way, particularly in the AFC, the winds are blowing, is the only way you have an opportunity to compete is by having a top 10 quarterback under center.
Yep.
Watson is that.
Yep.
The Browns realize that if they want any shot of hanging around the East, let alone the North in the AFC, they needed a game changer, and they disregarded everything else and made it happen.
This is either going to be a PR nightmare for them, depending on what happens, or they're going to have a chance to win a Super Bowl. Is there any in between here?
But let me go this route. Dude was 4-12.
Watson?
Yeah. Everybody makes this guy out to be the best. I mean, I'm not saying he's not, but he's 4-12, and how good of it? If you go by culture and everything else, I don't know. How good are the Browns?
I mean, he's going to be protected, which I don't think he was in Houston.
I will take it to my grave. Bill O'Brien destroyed the Texans.
Is he still the Alabama offensive coordinator?
Ooh,
or yes. He hasn't left yet, I don't think.
Yeah, how wild is that?
He went to Saban rehab.
He was coaching in Lucas Oil Stadium during the national championship.
It's insane.
Isn't that what?
Yeah.
Isn't that
nuts?
Yeah.
He might have been up top, but regardless, sure.
He's up top.
So you guys think that he makes him that much better?
Better how? What do you mean?
A Super Bowl good.
No.
Do they make them AFC champions? Are they better right now than your guys who just lost Tyreek Hill, if you didn't know?
No.
I think they have a shot to win that division.
I think they have they're in a much better position to win the North, and then you see what happens from there.
I mean, look at the QBs in that division. I mean,
it's Burrow and it's Watson, and that's it.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Disrespecting Lamar.
I
know I am.
Don't disrespect Lamar.
I think Lamar's going to have a bounce back this year. I am disrespecting Lamar.
Would you be happy if he was here?
Who? Watson?
Yep.
I don't think it would have been as much of like a puppies and rainbows happiness at the press conference as much as it was with Matt Ryan. There's a lot of smiling faces.
Oh my God.
I don't think I could root for him.
I couldn't.
So no, I wouldn't be happy. Yeah. Like if all I cared about was winning as a fan, then yes, but I don't.
I'll tell you what, they were playing some like Cleveland sports radio hits from callers on national ESPN radio. Like, the radio in Cleveland is nuts.
Crazy.
Was it positive?
It was a mixed bag.
But I'm guessing when they were positive, they were stupid positive. And when they were negative, they were stupid negative.
Yeah.
And in between, just stupid.
It was a lot of people calling in like, how are you a Browns fan? You can't root against the quarterback and be a Browns fan. It was a lot of that.
Because that is a football state. That is a proud fan base where I'm surprised that there's negativity about a signing like that. Not like ethically, I just mean like they care so much about the Browns. I'm surprised there is a divide in the fan base, at least from those colors.
I don't know.
Are you?
I don't know. I mean, haven't been there a couple hours away. Browns fans are interesting. It's the most collegiate fan base there is, meaning you can go in Bloomington every Sunday, man, Yogi's Browns Club. I mean, they got all over the country. They have Browns Club. Where are you going to go to pitch? Hey, we got a Browns Club. Like, I don't know of a Colts Club anywhere. I don't know of a Bears Club anywhere where you go to San Diego and, hey, where are we watching?
Surprised.
I know I would be, but Browns are more organized. Yes. Browns are more known. I'm not saying where people, hey, look, people watch a Colts game in Indianapolis. They
like
go
Cowboys, up, like yeah. Packers, oh, yeah. Stuff like that.
No question. But the Browns is a different deal. So I could see some of those fans, I think, being a little bit negative about it. Look, let's be honest. There are going to be people negative. There are going to be people that say they're negative just so they don't catch hell for saying, you know, publicly anyway, saying that they're all in on a guy that's got 22 cases of whatever the hell he did. Because that's what it is. 22 yeah. cases of what, yeah. What did you do?
On the field, I think he's a top five talent in the NFL.
All right.
Off the field stuff is what drives me away from
it. Is he going to play the first month?
I can't imagine. I think he's going to, he's gotten paid. I got to think he sits out 4 to 6.
I was going to say 6 to 8.
So. Who's their backup now? Is it Jacoby?
Was it Case Keenum? No. Yeah.
Who did Jacoby Brissett sign?
No, it was Case Keenum. Who came in and played well and everybody thought he was good? You know, it was Case Keenum because my boy Gregson always has a good backup. Just to piss you people off.
Currently, Jacoby's third string, but second.
They stole Case Keenum?
Baker's second, right?
Oh, that's just no, no, no.
So, oh, so it's that's true.
Yeah,
that's
Case Keenum went over to the Bills. He's the backup for the Bills.
But you're right. He's been on every team. Case I feel like Keenum he's a...
He's the Larry Brown of backup quarterbacks.
Correct.
Larry coached every team, and now Case Keenum, of course, is playing for every team. Yeah, they got him to the Bills. How about this? Seventh round pick. How many rounds are there?
Seven.
That's what I thought. Well, you remember Tom Brady was a 6th-round pick. Did you know that? Had you ever heard that?
I don't think I have.
No. All right, when we come back, we're going to talk to Rob Blackman, the Boilers in Philadelphia, taking on St. Peter's. Look, I'm not saying that they're going to lose. I think they win. I think they cover. But I'm going to tell you, tomorrow's a long day for Boiler coaches because all you're thinking of, oh, man, we can't lose to St. Peter's. How can we not? You know, blah, blah, blah. You wish you played that game at noon. You do. You wish you played that game at noon. All right, we'll be right back.
Jake Query here. You know, recently I returned to college to finish my degree, and I encourage you to join me. Whether you're like me and life simply got in the way, or you never went to college at all, Indiana offers financial assistance for those ready to move forward. If I can do it, I know you can too. If you're looking for a better job or doing it for your family, Indiana has grants to pay for over 150 certificates in high-wage industries. You're sure to find a tuition-free option that fits you. To apply, visit nextleveljobs.org today. Sponsored by the Indiana Commission for Higher Education. That's nextleveljobs.org.
When a health system treats patients with the very best in medical care and compassion, it needs a rare kind of staff. That's why Eskenazi Health never stops looking for professionals who understand that technology is most effective when paired with a genuine human touch. If you are
a nurse,
a social worker,
or another professional interested in a career with us, visit eskenazihealth.edu/careers. Eskenazi Health, one of Becker's 150 great places to work in healthcare.
Dan Dakich here for the Michalis Corporation, spelled like Michael is, but pronounced Michalis. If you need him, you'll be out. So glad that you called him at 844-FIX-INDY or go online at michaliscorp.com. It has been raining. If you need waterproofing, please do yourself a favor. If you've got any problems caused by water or wind, Michalis is the company. 844-FIX-INDY is the number. They are professional. They will be out. They will take care of everything you need. Waterproofing. Oh, man, something's blowing off or blowing into your house. Do yourself a favor. Call Michalis today. The Michalis Corporation is spelled like Michael is. 844-FIX-INDY is the number. Or MichalisCorp.com. Wind damage. Make sure you trust who I trust, Michalis.
Prescription products require an online physician consultation and are only available if the physician determines a prescription is appropriate. Subscription required. See website for full details and important safety information.
When you lose your hair, you lose more than just hair. You lose your confidence. But that doesn't have to happen. Today, there are proven medical solutions to stop hair loss and in some cases, regrow what you've lost. And now you can get them online at forhims.com, including the very latest treatment, topical finasteride and minoxidil spray. It combines two proven hair loss treatments in the only hair loss spray of its kind, and only forhims.com has it. No more pills, no more messy, time-consuming applications. Topical finasteride and minoxidil spray is only available by prescription, but at forhims.com, you can connect with a medical provider online who will, if appropriate, prescribe this new spray and ship it to your home. It's that easy. Get the old hair back. Get the old you back at forhims.com. For a free online consultation, go to forhims.com/care. Regrow your hair in 3 to 6 months at forhims.com/care. forhims.com/care.
Spring is upon us at Sundown Gardens. Fresh shipments of nursery stock, pansies, and pottery arriving daily. 186th Street and Spring Mill Road, sundowngardens.com.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
WIBC HD2, W298BB, WIBC HD3, W228CX, Indianapolis.
The Pacers head south to play the Memphis Grizzlies tonight at 7:30 on 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
It's the Dan Dakich Show, 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
I'm going to ask it because I just want to know why. Rob Blackman, the voice of the Purdue Boilermakers, getting ready to play in the Sweet 16, joins. Rob, may I just ask a very simple question?
Yes.
And that why does Purdue never have the drama that seems to come every 6 months with Indiana basketball? There is no drama with Purdue, man. It's just, let's just play. That's what it is. Why? Tell me why. Walk me through this.
Let me think. I don't know that I have a very good answer, although maybe I would say this, Dan, because I've heard you say this before. It's okay to date crazy, just don't marry crazy.
Right.
Does this make sense to you?
Right.
Because, listen, we've had a few crazy ones come through here in my 17 years.
Yes.
But they normally don't stick around very long. We don't get married to them, if that makes sense.
Yes. Absolutely. Don't marry crazy. Date a little crazy. A little crazy is good. Follow somebody, that has a cape. That's great. But don't marry. Purdue just keeps going along. They just win, lose, whatever. They look, if you lose, you lose. But they just keep going along, man. They just do. What are you thinking? How are we looking? What do you think of let's go St. Peter's first. What are your thoughts?
Well, they are not a big ball club, as is typically the case with, you know, a mid-major. Their tallest guy, DeHamie's like 6'10", and he plays off the bench, so they're more like 6'8", across the front line. But the one thing they do have that's given Purdue fits for a number of years is long athletic wings. And Defu really is their five, but really plays more like a three, is 6'7" and long. Rupert, the freshman, who's 6'8", really long. Drame, one of the Drame boys, well, both of them actually, 6'7", 200 pounds, long. That has given Purdue some fits over the years, just those long athletic wings. So that does have me a little concerned. St. Peter's does not strike me as a team that scores at a high clip. But they're very good defensively, and they really make it tough on you, especially the way they pressure the ball. So, and I know you talk a lot about this, Dan. I've heard Coach Painter talk about this. Easiest way to alleviate ball pressure, just throw it inside, right? Which Purdue should have an advantage there. But if Purdue can't throw it inside because they can't find a way to get it in there because the defense is too good, then Purdue's going to have some problems. So. I guess that's a long-winded way of saying I'm really concerned about how they're going to guard Purdue on the perimeter because I think they're more than capable. I just don't know if St. Peter's has enough offensively to beat Purdue.
When you look at where St. Peter's is and you say, all right, how has this worked? And because first round of the NCAA tournament, Rob, Michigan was down 15 or whatever it was. To Colorado State, had no offense because they had a size advantage, and they'd literally just stood around trying to feed it into the post, and they were always playing against a set defense. Purdue's going to have the same size advantage. When Purdue has played smaller teams, have they been good running their offense and still getting the ball inside without standing, holding, and watching? You know what I mean?
Yes, most of the time, yes. Now, Purdue did struggle I'm just thinking about games off the top of my head. The game at Penn State, Purdue struggled to get the ball inside. Now, that may have been more the Micah Shrewsbury effect than anything, because Penn State's not a big team, obviously, and Purdue had a major advantage there. But I thought against Texas on Sunday, where Purdue had a decided height advantage, I thought Purdue did a very good job, obviously, getting the ball inside against a team that's pretty similar to St. Peter's in that they're long and athletic on the wings. So that would lend me to have a little bit of confidence that this Purdue team can throw the ball inside the way they did against Texas on Sunday. I mean, 46 free throw shot. I mean, obviously you're doing something right, getting the ball to the rim and getting the ball inside and drawing contact from the opponent. So, but yeah, there have been a game or two. But for the most part, Dan, I feel like Purdue's done a good job this year of finding a way to get the ball inside and play inside out and play to their strengths.
From a Purdue side, what do you see as key in this game?
Well, if you can keep the turnovers down, and I know this is the exact same key I gave you when we talked about
Oh, I know. Yeah, I get it.
But I mean, it's been the story of this team, plain and simple. When Purdue's turnover numbers are low, they're damn near unbeatable. I mean, you look at their offensive efficiency numbers, you look at their offensive rebound percentage, all Purdue really has to do, quite frankly, to win a game is just have quality offensive possessions. Now, you give the ball away 12 or 15 times, and all of a sudden you're in a little bit of a pickle. But Purdue did a good job of taking care of the ball against Yale, did a good job taking care of the ball against Texas. And more importantly, when they did turn it over, rarely was it live ball turnovers that led to runouts for the other team. So I think for this Purdue team, especially really the last 2 months or so of the season, it's really been one very simple simple denominator. And that is, if you don't turn the ball over, you're probably going to win the game because you're good enough offensively that the other team can't just line up in their half-court defense and stop you. Most teams just aren't good enough to do that. But, you know, you turn the ball over, you put them in an advantageous position where they have some easy runouts, and all of a sudden, instead of having, 75 shots at the basket, or you're down to 60 or so because you turned the ball over 15 times, then you're going to be in some trouble.
The great Rob Blackman, the voice of the Purdue Boilermakers, joins us on the hotline, brought to you by The Mower Shop in Fishers. Go to themowershop.com. See my boy, Paulie. How is Purdue's health? How is Sasha's hands? How's everybody's health right here? What we got?
Well, I'm here at practice right now, and everyone is practicing, and everyone looks healthy to me. It is funny you bring up Sasha's, because he dislocated that finger right on the non-shooting hand 4 or 5 games ago, and he just doesn't seem to have shot the ball the same. Now, I don't know if that makes any difference. He's not taping it, or he's not wearing any type of a splint or anything. But, man, it seems like ever since he dislocated that finger, for whatever reason, he cannot find the basket. He went 0-for in that game against Texas, 3-point shooting, which is only the third time all year he's had a game where he didn't make a 3-point basket. So I would say if there's any health concern, that would be the only one. But again, I don't even know if it is a concern. Like I said, it's not taped up. I don't know what to say. Just for whatever reason, ever since that happened, and again, it was the non-shooting end, he just has really struggled to make 3-point shots. Maybe that just means he has a few coming this weekend, hopefully.
Yeah, I mean, look, water finds its level. I say it all the time. You know what I mean? I mean, what the heck?
Hey. That's the thing. I mean, he's the best 3-point shooter on this team, and the guy's made 200 and whatever 20 some threes in his career. So yes, one would assume water finds its level with him, and if he happened to find it here on Friday and Sunday, that would be okay by me. Let me just put it that way.
Hey, honest to God, it is fun. It has been. It's been a fun ride all year. Is Purdue playing with? Is there any desperation here? You know what I mean? Like, do you feel that? Is that something that's in the mix?
I don't feel it, but I always feel weird. Also, speaking for the players, I've been asked this a couple of times, Dan. I mean, I don't know that these guys think much about. I don't know. I'm pretty certain they don't think twice about the fact Purdue hasn't been to a Final Four since 1980. I mean, holy cow, I was 9 years old when they went to the Final Four last, and I'm currently 51 years old. So I'm sure as hell pretty confident these guys don't know, don't care, quite frankly. And I don't mean that in a negative way, but, I mean, these guys are 19, 20 years old, dude, 21 years old. They don't – they 1980 to them might as well be the Dark Ages. So I don't know if they feel any extra pressure or anything like that. They just strike me as a team that's been having a heck of a lot of fun playing basketball. I know that, especially watching Jaden Ivey. He seems to be having the time of his life right now, and that normally is a good thing for Purdue. When he's in the right frame of mind, he is, man, he is awfully tough to guard.
Hey, how good is he defensively?
Certainly gotten much better. Now, yeah. He still gets lost away from the ball, and you probably see that when you watch his play. But his on-ball defense has gotten much better. And one thing I've noticed with him, Dan, when he feels challenged, when the guy he's guarding, you know, is a quality player and can get buckets, I think he takes it up to an extra notch. I think he takes that personal. Now, again, his off-the-ball defense and his sticking to his rules defensively, especially away from the ball, they can be a bit lax at times. That's putting it kindly. But, yes, on-the-ball defense, when he takes it personal, he all of a sudden becomes a very, very good on-ball defender.
Coach Katie's traveling with the crew, huh?
He is. It was nice to see him. Yeah, he was on the flight with us yesterday, and he's here with us in Philadelphia. And he was not with us in Milwaukee, so I was awfully happy to see that. Yes, he did make the trip to Philly.
Last thing before I'll let you go, when you look at teams that Purdue has played, and this is a tough question, but you have a great memory. You're smart. I'm not. You are. Is there anybody that St. Peter's, you know, Purdue fans can say, okay, they're comparable to that you can remember Purdue's played?
That's
a tough question.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe Wright State, which that's a tough comparison because that was the very first game of the year in November. So that was like November 15th. So that was a long time ago. Other than that, quite frankly, Dan, I think they and Yale have a lot in common, right? They don't necessarily score the ball at a high level, but they do really guard you. They make it tough on you, especially inside the arc to score the ball. They swarm the ball when it gets inside and dare you to make open jump shots. Now, the one thing Yale had that I don't think St. Peter's has, hopefully this doesn't come back to haunt me, but Yale had Swain, who was a really, really good individual offensive player and could basically get a shot whenever he wanted. I don't know if St. Peter's has that guy on their roster, but maybe Yale, maybe Wright State. It's really kind of hard for me to think about teams that these guys might compare to.
Yeah, I figured that's a tough question, but I got a lot of people were asking me that on my email and everywhere else, so I figured I might as well ask it. When more than two people ask a similar question, I'm like, all right, I'll ask the question. I got to keep the people happy here, big guy. You know what I mean?
Understood. Yeah, yes, yeah. Sir.
Well, have a great trip. I can hear practice in the background. Hopefully nobody gets hurt and the game goes Purdue's way, because it's certainly more fun when folks from here are still playing, brother. So good luck,
man. Isn't that right? Absolutely, Dan. Thanks for having me, man.
That's Rob Blackman. What am I talking about? That's you. Yeah. At Dan, in Pig's defense, he's been quick to shoot down Fife smearing on the boards. Yeah, is that right? That's because they want to do it. That's because that's what they did. Yeah, just read what Rab John said. No, these guys, no, the guy says they simply laid out the point. No, they didn't. They laid out what they were told were the points. Why don't they lay out the points from Nebraska, from the Northwestern? Let's do that. No, don't give me that crap. You guys, you want to have information so bad that you will believe crap. It's the Indiana way, man. It's the Indiana way. When somebody leaves, you got to smear them. When you got to fire somebody and it might come back on you, you got to smear them. Indiana went 2-11 against the best teams in the league. Indiana got beat by 30 to St. Mary's. Don't tell me that Indiana had a serious problem at Northwestern. And it wasn't just curfew. So just stop. Stop. With it. Just stop. It's the Indiana way to smear when people aren't there. And that's exactly what you saw Mike Woodson do. Exactly. So, you know, I'm sure they'll try to smear me. Good. Please do. I mean, you ain't nothing if you don't have a nice, you know, hit piece done on you. But I'm just telling you, don't even think that you're going to convince me otherwise. You can convince yourselves. Go do that, man. Go convince each other. Please do it. You know what I mean? Hey, go do it. Yay, rah. Go fight, win. But you ain't talking. You're talking to a guy who's been in these meetings now and said, no, I ain't doing that. With Woody, you're talking about a guy that learned from the two best, Knight and James Dolan. Don't even try it. I mean, if you're down there, you better check your phone. Yeah, you better check your damn phone. Make sure it's not bugged. Just telling you. Be careful. Be very, 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 very careful. And everybody, you know why I'm not, you know, if Dane did something as egregious and I knew it as what they are saying, I'd talk about it. I got no problem talking about it. But I ain't listening to these guys who were force-fed by Woodson and his staff. That's how Indiana operates, and that's how Indiana has operated for years. I've told you this before. I'll never forget, I went in to save Mike Giomi when I was a plastic coach. I'll move him in with me. I want him on the team. He's a good player. Blah, 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 blah. Uwe and Alte, you know, blah, 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 blah. Knight lost his mind. Giomi leaves. Next thing you know, everybody wants to smear somebody. I ain't doing it. Butt ass, if you don't like it, take your ass on out of here. But if you want to fire Dane Fife, fire him. But don't bury him in some chicken blank release after you've been chicken blank the whole time walking around at Northwestern shoot around. I got people that were there. And oh, by the way, I've not talked to Dane. Last time I talked to Dane, he was asking me what he thought I could do to help him make what's-his-face better, Cooper Kupp, or whatever the guy's name is, the TikTok guy. So just stop with that BS. Anyway, if you don't like a guy, you got a problem with a guy, you don't talk to a third. That's a Bob Knight crap. Samson tried to do that with me with his wife and daughter after we beat Wisconsin. Or no. After we beat, what was it? Whatever Samson's last game, Michigan State or whether it was Purdue, I can't remember. I walked in, I go, whoa. I could tell. I'm like, all right. So then I waited and I went to go see Samson the next day and MF'd him and he MF'd me. And that was the last time I spoke to him. He didn't MF me. He looked shocked. So let's just be honest. That's the Indiana way. And that's what I've said. And what might be one of the reasons Indiana has been in the situation they've been in, because integrity, toughness, all that is not exactly there. Not exactly when you won't speak to a guy directly until you get the AD in there and then it's time to fire him, which is what I assumed happened yesterday, because there's not a chance in hell that Woodson just said, you're fired. That's the Bob Knight. That's where Bob Knight, remember when Bob Knight hit Felling? That's that deal. You don't do that anymore. You got to have, you know, I probably had an HR guy in there too, I would assume. Dane didn't like the NIL. That's total crap. Oh, Jordan Mazuski. There you go. Now, he's a new one. There you go. He got to be a blogger boy. I guarantee you he is. He's got, well, recruiting response. That dude wouldn't know. That's what you're supposed to do, right? All I know is this. While Woody was off doing whatever Woody does, right? Guess what? Dane was out there representing Indiana in front of a national audience. When all of the people were running freaking scared. Kim Kreiner Allen says, I am an IU reject. All right, I'll take that. I got no problem with that. That's all good. I'm not mad. One guy says that I am not even worthy. Sarah says, Dan, maybe not. Regardless, the only point of that tweet is you're a blank, which says a lot about you as a human. Uh-oh, we got says a lot person. The double and triple downing says even more about you as a human, because Sarah knows. You are a childhood idol of mine. Obviously, as an adult, you learn childhood heroes aren't perfect, but to learn that one is just a complete blank, I accept all of Indiana people, because you're not really Indiana people. You're not really Indiana people. You're just whiners, bitchers, and moaners. You got nothing to do with Indiana. But anyway, Dane, you want to fire him? Fire him. That's your prerogative. Nobody ever said Dane was the heir apparent. Nobody ever said that. You guys said that. So everybody's praising Woodson for using I instead of, yeah, Woodsy's a gutsy guy. Gutsy. Right. Right. Yeah. Anyway, it's the Indiana way, man. I've said it for years. If I'm mad at you, I don't sit you down. I talk about you. Knight was the best, man. Knight was the absolute best at talking about someone. Woody, great at talking about someone. Hey, can you believe what this guy did? Hey, can you believe what that guy did? Hey, can you believe? Instead of with Fife right there, at least according to two people that were at the Northwestern practice. Fife's right there. Yeah, gutsy. That's why I ask, is Indiana in a better position now than they were a year ago? I don't know. I know you all think so. 2-11 against good teams. You got all this nonsense. You got a guy in there that won't, you know, that does what Woodson does, which is, you know, now we're going to smear. Of course, I mean, where do you think these guys get? Like, where do you think Rab Johns gets this from? Like, do you think this just is what he knows because he's in the building? Do you think that these guys that are writing these things, do you think they actually know because they're so smart on recruiting and they know what you read is what they are told? Now, I'm sorry, but that's just the truth. And you can hate on me all you'd like, but that's the truth. Rab Johns writes what he's told. And I don't blame Jeff. Hey, good for him, man. That's, you know, you're trying to bring people to your site, and I'm doing a hell of a job for you. But it's all spin from Woodson. It's all smear. It's all it is. How else would they know? How would they know about talking political? How would they know whatever these things are that they're saying? And explain to me, how would they know? I'll hang up and listen. They know for one reason. One reason. And one reason only. The staff or somebody on that staff or somebody appointed by that staff decided that they were going to tell the media to smear Dane to get you all off of him and onto Dane, which is so chicken blank, but it's so expected by Woody and others that can't separate themselves. And Woodson is, if he can stop eating, can come on this show anytime. I ain't asking him. Because I don't give a damn if he comes. Because I know the deal. Are you kidding me? I know the deal. Dan, move on. You're obsessed with this. No, not a chance, bruh. People want you to move on. But no. Mm-mm. No. It's just amazing. You guys that are believing this crap being said about Dane, you only believe it because it's on the right side of you. If this were something that wasn't on your side, you'd never believe it. And the comparison I make is you folks that listen to everything Fox says, don't believe anything from CNN, and anybody that watches CNN doesn't believe anything from Fox. So those of you that are absolutely in love with Indiana and can't think for yourself, you're listening to all this going, yeah, see? See? And those of you that are against, I'm in the middle, man. I'm just like, this is what Indiana does, bro. So I anticipate a smear campaign coming out on me. Please, God, do. Last smear campaign that came out on me, like one of the guys that got suspended, one of your heroes, Xavier Johnson, who, by the way, did get suspended for a variety of things. You all loved him, Woodson's daughter. You all loved him. I loved it too, man. Got me to 1 million likes, impressions, just made me another 20 grand. So bring the smear campaign on Indiana. Please, Scotty D, the rest of you, bring it, baby. Bring it. Please. I would be disappointed if Greg, Greg and I are going back and forth, but I don't think Greg is the kind of guy that would do that. Now, Dana, she'd do it in a second because she wants to be popular, but I can't imagine Greg would. Osterman, of course, he's got a, you know, he's got to do what he's got to do, right? I mean, Osterman's got to keep the got to keep everybody happy so that they'll tell him stuff, because he certainly doesn't know. And the same with all these guys. I get it. Who's next? You'll see. You will see. Lander leaving. I told you he's a child. He needed to leave. That's all good. And away you go. Jacob Snyder couldn't get it more wrong. Nothing wrong, but had disagreements with Woodson. That's not it at all. Not even close. All right, 317-239-1070. If you would like to chime in on that, Dan at 1070thefan.com. Wait, you'll tell. You think I'm lying? Smear campaign's already started, just like Bob Knight. Remember when Knight needed a letter out? Where'd he go? Pigs. You think it's a coincidence that all of a sudden Woodson is speaking at thepigs.com? Thepigs.com golf outing? You think that? Oh, it's just a coincidence. What did he learn from the best, man? Watch your phones, people. Watch your phones. Because James Dolan wasn't afraid, man. If Knight knew how to do it, shoot. Are you kidding me? Knight would have tapped your phone today, tomorrow, the next day. The smear campaign is on. Let's see where it leads us. Should be a fun weekend. We'll be back.
Spring is upon us at Sundown Gardens. Fresh shipments of nursery stock, pansies and pottery arriving daily, 186th Street and Spring Mill Road, sundowngardens.com.
Make your first wager with the King of Sportsbooks and win big during BetMGM's March matchups. Download the BetMGM app and place a $10 moneyline wager on any college tournament game. If any team hits a three-pointer during the tournament, you'll win $200 in free bets. Just use the code MM200. Again, that's MM200 when you register. Plus, you'll earn BetMGM rewards points that can be redeemed for online bonuses or converted into comps at MGM Resorts. Sign up today and, again, use that code MM200 to win $200 if any team hits a three during BetMGM's March matchups. Visit BetMGM.com for terms and conditions. Must be 21 years of age or older to wager. Indiana-only new customer offer. All promotions are subject to qualification and eligibility requirements. Rewards issued as non-withdrawable free bets or site credit. Free bets expire 7 days from issuance. If you or someone you know has a gambling problem and wants help, call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
Hey, this is Spencer Thompson from Thompson Furniture Mattress in Columbus. Since 1927, our family has served Central Indiana with the best service and quality furniture by Indiana-made Smith Brothers of Bern, Lazy Boy, and FlexSteel. Made in the USA mattresses by Tempur-Pedic and Stearns & Foster, and all-weather outdoor furniture by Berlin Gardens and Pollywood. We guarantee the lowest price and free delivery. Better prices, better quality, better get the Thompson Furniture Mattress in Columbus.
Don't rely on just your cell phone to connect to the internet. Enjoy a year of free high-speed home internet service when you add one line of unlimited mobile with 5G for only $30 a month. When you qualify for affordable connectivity plan at Xfinity, that's right. Get fast, reliable home internet for free when you add one line of unlimited mobile with 5G for only $30 a month. That's right. Act now to get this incredible deal so you can enjoy more streaming, gaming, chatting, sharing, and everything else that you love for less. With free high-speed internet at home and unlimited mobile with 5G, you never have to settle for just one. To learn more, go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit an Xfinity store today. Requires paperless billing, auto pay with stored bank account, ends 4/28/22. Restrictions apply. New Connect internet, 50 megabytes per second. Customers with Xfinity Mobile Unlimited line. Equipment taxes, fees extra, subject to change after term. Regular rate supply, taxes and fees extra. Xfinity internet required. Reduced speeds after 20 gigabytes of usage.
Of course, she needs a college education, but I don't want her buried in student loans for the rest of her life.
It starts here.
She needs a school with great resources, but some of these campuses are so big.
The School of Health and Human Sciences at IUPUI has the resources of a big university on a campus with a hometown feel. It's a more affordable option with access to career paths in Indy's world-class healthcare and sports entertainment hospitality organizations.
At those big schools, I'm worried she'll just be a number.
Hey, it starts here.
Hey, why not IUPUI?
That's what I was thinking.
The need for healthcare workers is growing, and a health sciences degree prepares students for growing careers as physician's assistant or for pre-med and pre-PT and OT programs. Partnerships at Indy hospitals and research facilities provide hands-on learning opportunities.
The School of Health and Human Sciences at IUPUI. It starts here. Learn more at shhs.iupui.edu.
Hey, Andy. Tim Pearsant here, founder of Chattanooga Whiskey. Did you know March Madness and Chattanooga Whiskey have a lot in common? For example, we selected our flagship bourbon recipe through Bracketology. That's right. After years of distilling and barreling hundreds of experimental recipes, barrel number 91 emerged as our champion. We now call it Chattanooga Whiskey 91, an award-winning small batch bourbon. Featuring notes like toasted honey and graham cracker, we think you'll enjoy it as much as we do. Drink Chattanooga Whiskey, enjoy responsibly.
You're always up for some fun with the family, so you order the essentials, a new board game, some baking supplies, and even a new projector for outdoor movie night. And with the Bank of America Customized Cash Rewards credit card, you can choose to earn 3% cash back on online shopping, which could increase to up to 5.25% as a preferred rewards member. Rewards which you can put toward an extra treat that everyone will enjoy, like an old-fashioned popcorn machine. Visit bankofamerica.com/more rewarding and apply now. Copyright 2021 Bank of America Corporation.
Warmer weather means more fun time outside, but it can also mean more bugs like fleas and ticks. So don't forget to help protect your pets with Frontline Plus for dogs and Frontline Plus for cats. It's easy to apply, kills fleas and ticks fast, and keeps working all month long. So you can enjoy the outdoors and your pets can get the protection they need. That's why Frontline is the number one name in flea and tick protection. Trusted for over 20 years. Find out where to buy Frontline products at frontline.com today.
If you love listening to our shows, then you've got to follow us on our social media. You can find us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. Search 107.5 The Fan and share your opinions with us on our posts.
He is the new quarterback for your Indianapolis Colts.
Okay, we got our guy. We can worry about other stuff now.
Does Matt Ryan make the Colts a Super Bowl threat?
Jimmy, what are we doing?
If you're talking about it.
The Colts just got better quarterback. Be part of an organization that has an incredible history.
We're talking about it.
Go get Matt Ryan and then draft a quarterback.
Matt Ryan, best quarterback in the division.
Your home for Indy sports. 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan. It's the Dan Dakich Show, 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
And absolutely, Jody Shelton, who I really like, yet. It wasn't a, hey, simple, it didn't work out with Dane, man. And I've explained it all morning, and you've been listening all morning, so I don't know where else to tell you. But the truth of the matter is, there are a lot of chicken blame. It's Indiana stuff, man. It's always Indiana stuff. It's always, you know, just stuff. It's always chicken blank Indiana stuff. Instead of like, hey, man, firing you. The guy said, well, he could have resigned. Yeah, he could have. Suppose. But I wouldn't trust people in Indiana to get me my money. I wouldn't trust that. I wouldn't trust that even a little bit. I wouldn't trust none of those people at Indy. I like Scotty, though. I would trust Scotty, I think. But, yeah, I don't. I'm not. Hey, look. All I'm telling you is this. This is Indiana University all over again. To all of a sudden get to Pigs, get to Jeff Rabjohns, and have him come out with, well, you know, it was this. Dan, no one will care about Fife this time next year. Maybe not, but I will. Look, I'm just telling you. I mean, I love Indiana University men's basketball. Not gonna lie, love it. I love it. It's part of who I am. It's inside me. You all can say, well, you're bitter. I'm not bitter about a damn thing. I absolutely got no freaking nothing. I was happy the day when I didn't get the job. But the truth of the matter is, the fact of the matter is, oh, here we go. I've got contacts in Bloomington that state very specifically Fife refused several attempts by Woodson to be reined in. It was a toxic relationship. I had heard about the infighting in February. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, by my sources, Do you know how many of these dumbass sources say so many ridiculous things about me? Finally, I had to go on a website and say, just stop, man. Just, what are you doing? But anyway, it is the Indiana way. We will not, and I'll participate in as much as anybody. I'm not going to sit here and tell you I'm not. I'll tell you this right now. I'll smear whatever because I'm flat out tired of it. But I'm sitting there watching, man, and I'm like, wow. I read that release, and I'm like, whoa. If Fan Dyfe was an assistant, no one would care. Oh, that's not true. Brandon, I'm going to answer this last one because I know you don't know. But, no, Indiana fans don't. All they care about is winning. Didn't used to. When they got rid of Samson, they were winning. Dan, you've beaten a dead horse for 3 hours. Talk about something. John, please feel free to go somewhere else. This is the biggest story of the day. We still got 500 people listening, bro. Bruh. Dan, years ago, I had an inside source. My friend's dad was one of the janitors. Bet I knew him. Dan, could you see Fife going back to Michigan State? I don't know. I don't know. I think that Dane will probably have opportunity. If, like I said earlier, Ball State were smart, and Ball State's going to overthink it, but you know what? They've never really, truly been smart with their post. McCollum was a good hire. You had to hire McCollum, right? You had to. You did. I mean, he did well. I mean, he got to the tournament. Ray did a good job there. He did. But since then, you know, they tried to go diversity. That's the only reason you hired John Thompson III. That dude was a stone idiot. I loved him, though. I thought he was great. Hell, he was so bad. We were playing with football players. I think we broke a 10-game losing streak there. Just be smart. Seriously, just be smart. And hire either Dane, Mike Lewis, or Terry Johnson. I mean, it ain't hard. Very, very easy. Sam Blair. Now, really, Sam? Oh, really, because here's what you get into here. Oh, sounds like he didn't leave. He was shown to couldn't figure the NIL system, recruit and retain talent, as well as repeatedly promoting his own personal agenda. Oh, shut up. I mean, why? Because Jeff Rabjohns wrote that? I think you might find, if you really look at it, there's a little bit of the opposite going on there with the political agendas. But I don't know. I don't know. Might be a little bit opposite there with the political agendas. Yeah. Just saying. Might be a little bit. Yeah. Hey, Dan, I'm so tired of the drama with IU basketball. It's Chrissy. Not good. They haven't been good for 25 years. I agree. I tried to explain this in 2008 when I was talking to that guy. What the hell was his name? Harry Gonzo, about character. And I actually gave his own, what's the right word? I gave him a way to go about it. You know, and then I gave it at the end of the day. I think one of these clowns, I think Osterman or one of these guys won an award. Maybe a kid named Cohen won an award because they did a story on me. And my come to Jesus, what Indiana needs after we lost to Arkansas, and Indiana still hasn't figured it out. They haven't. They haven't figured it out, man. I'm just telling you. Dan, assistant coach, we're talking this. Are you crazy, son? This is what you don't understand. And I'll say this again. Dane Fife was the guy that stood up when all the adults in the room were cowering. Dane was still there. Dane was the guy with a camera in front of him explaining to the world how Indiana should be. There was a loyalty to about Dane. While Knight and Knight's assistants were trying to get Dane and all those guys to go to a junior college. No, what Dane did was answer every question, lead, along with Tommy Coverdale, along with A.J. Moy. There's some leaders on that crew now. They did. But at the end of the day, you know what? Oh, imagine it. Hey, Brandon, imagine if this was your guy, Hunter. You'd be crying. I get it. Brandon, I know what your game is, bruh. Dan, I guess my question is, if he didn't do anything of this and it's just a smear campaign, why'd they find him? No, I'm not saying what he, there's a lot, you know, it didn't work, but you don't have to smear the guy after. Kevin, Kevin, I know you're one of those nuts pigs guys. I get it, you got a fish and you're one of those nuts guys that loses your mind on me. I understand. But yeah, great. Whatever the situation was, you want to fire the guy, fire the guy. But there's no reason to put out what they put out. And there's no reason to go to Jeff Rabjohns and have him put out what he put out. There's just no reason for it. But hey, man. Nah, Braden, unless he fires Hunter, man, you know the deal, right? Yeah, man, we know the deal. And then it's, of course, you know. Right, Brandon, right. Anyway, yeah, if this report is accurate from Pigs, yeah, well, I'm sure it is. Yeah, if you think that's absolute, you think that's a report from Pigs? Or do you think that is a smear campaign from Woodson? And if you don't know the difference, I can't help you. And I guarantee you there are fake accounts on here that are going right to the Indiana basketball office to make sure that this thing gets out there. How do you think that anybody would get this type of information, true or false? You're not smart enough? Well, all I'm telling you is Woody and staff, or Woody's guy, whatever it is, guarantee you. They came up with a thing. They expounded on little things, made them bigger, no question. I want to know what happened in Northwestern. Coach Hunter. That's what I'd like to know. Coach Hunter, Kenya, Woody, what happened in Northwestern? No. What happened? Well, Pigs, you think anybody's going to tell? Why didn't, let me ask you, if you guys believe Jeff Rabjohns and everything Rabjohns is saying, and this isn't a smear campaign, right? Why didn't they, because they have all this information Rabjohns has. Why didn't he have information on what happened at Northwestern? About guys coming in off elevators, about towels under doors, about the smell of antiseptic to cover up the, you know, the skunk smell. Why didn't they have that? Why? Because they're all in pocket. I mean, they got all this information. I mean, I would think if you, when if you weren't in pocket at Pigs, or you weren't in pocket with a star, you, and now you're going to write all this stuff, why didn't you write the stuff when the Northwestern stuff hit, if you have all this information? Or do you just have information provided to you that every single reasonable human being can look at and say, well, yeah, I'm sure that didn't happen. Dan, is it a smear campaign because it's detailing something you don't like? Absolutely not. Absolutely. Right. Just buy edibles, Jennifer. Right. All I know is this, man. When the boys and girls of Indiana were cowering. Fife was right out there, man. So, Woody, you started your career in Alaska being an idiot. You ended your career losing to Purdue in the NCAA tournament, and then we really never saw you again. I would argue Dane Fife is the one making the decision on who's always a part of the Indiana family. We'll be back.
Save up to $500 on a king bed for a queen price at Mattress Firm today. Plus, take home a free adjustable base. That's a $499 value with qualifying purchases.
Every dribble, every pass, and every bucket, all in the palm of your hand. Because now you can sign up and bet. No strings attached with Bet River Sportsbook app, featuring award-winning customer service. Live in-game bets, player props, and instant betting, bucket to bucket. Don't miss out on all the big games. Get in the action with Bet River Sportsbook app.
Must be 21. Must be located in Indiana. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-9-WITH-IT. 1-800-994-8448.
Golfers, you're invited to make the short trip to experience Antler Point Golf Course in Rushville. Antler Point is under new ownership and just underwent renovations and is ready for you to experience this spring. Weekday specials, senior specials, and affordable weekends, 18 or 9 holes. AntlerPointGolf.com is less than an hour from Indy. You want to play more golf in 2022? Give Antler Point Golf Course in Rushville a swing. You'll be glad you came. AntlerPointGolf.com. That's point with an E. See you soon.
Hey guys, it's the new year. Are you still struggling with erectile dysfunction? I've yet to meet anyone that enjoys timing those intimate moments around a pill. Well, now you don't have to. The advanced wave technology at Pine Grove Medical Clinic has been shown by Cambridge University and the Cleveland Clinic to restore and even regrow blood vessels. It can improve circulation and eliminate erectile dysfunction. No pills and no side effects. If you're ready to put a stop to your ED, call us in the next 2 minutes and you'll receive a consultation, assessment, and blood flow ultrasound free. Plus, a special gift that produces immediate results in the bedroom. You're going to love that. Trust me. This is a $600 value, free to callers now. 317-552-1111. That's 317-552-1111. Guys, get rid of your ED and get that spark back. Call Pine Grove Medical Clinic now to qualify. 317-552-1111.
Jake Query here. You know, recently I returned to college to finish my degree, and I encourage you to join me. Whether you're like me and life simply got in the way, or you never went to college at all, Indiana offers financial assistance for those ready to move forward. If I can do it, I know you can too. If you're looking for a better job or doing it for your family, Indiana has grants to pay for over 150 certificates in high-wage industries. You're sure to find a tuition-free option that fits you. To apply, visit nextleveljobs.org today. Sponsored by the Indiana Commission for Higher Education. That's nextleveljobs.org.
Prescription products require an online physician consultation and are only available if the physician determines a prescription is appropriate. Subscription required. See website for full details and important safety information.
When you lose your hair, you lose more than just hair. You lose your confidence. But that doesn't have to happen. Today, there are proven medical solutions to stop hair loss, and in some cases, regrow what you've lost. And now you can get them online at forhims.com, including the very latest treatment, topical finasteride and minoxidil spray. It combines two proven hair loss treatments in the only hair loss spray of its kind, and only forhims.com has it. No more pills, no more messy, time-consuming applications. Topical finasteride and minoxidil spray is only available by prescription, but at forhims.com, you can connect with a medical provider online who will, if appropriate, prescribe this new spray and ship it to your home. It's that easy. Get the old hair back. Get the old you back at forhims.com. For a free online consultation, go to forhims.com/care. Regrow your hair in 3 to 6 months at forhims.com/care. forhims.com/care.
1 point lead for Plymouth. They got the ball inbounds. Oh, they got it. 3 seconds. 2, 1. It's over. Plymouth has won the state championship.
Hey, that is Scott Skiles, 1982 game to remember against Plymouth. A 75-74 over the Veldt. Gary Roosevelt, Skiles 39. Great performance. Beating Ronaldo Thomas, Jerry Baker on the call of the state and scoring at 30.2. 1788, that's how many career points he had. It was a career record at Plymouth till 05. Played Ohio State, senior year MVP of the Big Ten. 850 points in the season, 22nd pick of the Bucks in the 86 draft, 10 season, played all over the place, Bucks, Pacers, Magic, Bullets, 76ers, head coach from 99 to 2016 for the Suns, the Bucks, the Bulls, the Magic. You can see future stars in person for a whole lot less money than what you'll pay to watch them here or in College of the Pros. IHSA Boys Basketball State Finals Sunday. Oh, no, they're not. They're Saturday. New champs in all four classes. Communities from all around the state dressed in their team's colors will fill pro arenas with high school cheers. You'll get goosebumps. I always do. Maybe the last time some players, may not be the last time some players Saturday step on a pro court. 30 former Indiana high school players now in the NBA. How about that action? You have a chance to say, I was there. When you buy a ticket, you're directly supporting the athletic department of your local school with critical life lessons that high school sports teach. You're supporting the purest form of sports. Don't miss it. Nothing compares to an IHSA state final.
Friday on Kevin and Query, Sweet 16 rolls on. Taking a look back at the Thursday night games, previewing Purdue, and Rake and Joe Wiz join us. Fun begins at 7, 93.5, 107.5 The Fan.
and Dakich Show, 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
Welcome back. Yeah, Jimmy, we got hoops tonight. We got Dane Fife fired. We got hoops. We got IHSA Boys State Finals. Mike Renfro was in here a couple days ago. We also had earlier today on the drive. I was going to go drivehubler.com. No, on the mower shop. We had Rob Blackman. We also are in the drivehubler.com studio. Jimmy, what's your official best bet of tonight? I know it's coming up. I know it is, but what's it going to be?
The Jay Cook plays of the day.
This is me, all right? I'm not a athlete. This is my way. This is how I win.
Today's plays of the day, all Sweet 16 games, laying the five with the Villanova Wildcats as they take on the Michigan Wolverines. Also going to extend the Coach K retirement tour another week, taking the Duke Blue, not another week, but another day, taking the Duke Blue Devils toward the money line against Texas Tech. Like to parlay that if you're interested with the Arizona Wildcats, their other play of the day, to win the money line against the Houston Cougars. And in that same game, taking Benedict Mathurin over 18.5 total points against Houston. 3-1 yesterday, 7-3 on the week, 125-99-4 on the year. Plays on Twitter at the Jay Cook.
That's it, Jimmy. Jimmy, if I were going to go to a parlay tonight, what would I take?
Arizona and Duke.
That's your one. I know that's you up for that. It's a lock.
And chips all in, Dan.
Chips all in? Chips oh my God, not chips all in. Hold on, look around. Chips all in?
Chips are all in.
Wow. Wow. I've been trying to get Jack Davison on the show. Just telling you. Man, oh man. Trying. Wabash College. All these guys suddenly with made-up exaggerated info on five, courtesy of the IU basketball office. Why no inside info on the hotel incidents at Northwestern? Why not? Don't know. I am watching the Bob. Somebody sent me this. The Bob Knight firing from Channel 13. And the Bob Knight firing, there's Dane. Meanwhile, I don't know where Woody was. I mean, I'm sure he was probably in a bunker with Coach Knight, we got to get Buckner down here. We got to get him down here. Well, Dane's out there battling, right? Oh, man. Dan, two quick things. Whatever happened to Big in Tuesdays, would you rather speak at the Millie Schembechler golf outing or the Pigs.com golf outing? Well, Woody's got the Pigs.com information. Hey, look, Woody, we'll protect you here if you will, speak at our golf outing. That's how that works. I honest to God, you guys, and I ain't even mad about it. Why would we be mad? You know what happens? I know how it works. Somebody will come out later on that, well, you know, he was scheduled to speak here, you know, weeks ago. Yeah, okay. All right. Cool. Dan, there you go. I don't know who was in charge of what recruiting. I don't know nothing, man. I just wonder why there isn't more information on the hotel incidents up at Northwestern. We got all this information all of a sudden out of nowhere. Very detailed information. The politics of Dane Fife, the this, the that, very detailed. It can only come from one place, ladies and gentlemen. I know you're smart enough, but man, Michael Durr in the transfer portal, that's not a bad thing. That would not be awful. Michael Durr, one of the suspended guys. I'm sure the basketball program at Indiana will treat Michael Durr with far more respect than they treated Dane Fife. Again, don't have any problem if Mike Woodson wants to fire Dane Fife. However, if you in fact are going to fire Dane Fife, at least do it with a little bit of dignity and class. At least do it where your big fat head coach ego doesn't have to put out slander. It's not real slander, but you know what I'm talking about, against a guy that was there for Indiana when Indiana needed him most. That's it. That's all I got. I mean, just say we have gone separate ways, blah, 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 and away we go. That's what you do. Just saying. People are telling me that Stewart has hit the portal. All right. Don't know if that's true. I just read it. Could be true. Could not be true. Go to Pigs. They got the pipeline to the Indiana basketball. You guys act like I don't know. I know. Shoot. Shoot. See what I did there? See what I did there, Jimmy? I went, shoot. Well, I was going to, but I caught myself.
I'm proud of you.
Thank you. I'm growing up. I'm growing into the job, Jimmy.
A pro's pro.
I'm. What's Stewart's name? Parker? Parker Stewart. He is another one of the suspended. Where's Pigs on that, man? Why don't they say what happened up there? Why were there towels stuffed under doors? Hard to say. Jimmy, are you okay today?
Me?
Yeah, Tyreek Hill got traded.
Why? Why?
I don't know. I don't feel good about
Dan,
it.
Dan, I barely have a Band-Aid on that wound. Come on. I am good.
All right.
The NCAA tournament is back on.
Yeah, it is.
Woo!
Whatever you got to do, it's got to be done by 7. I told Lee, get the wine bottles because tomorrow's my day to sleep in. Tomorrow is Sunday. There's no show tomorrow. Yeah.
There's a show here, though.
There. Oh, yeah. Noon to 3. Can't wait. I haven't seen where Parker Stewart's gotten into portal. Did I miss something? Is somebody telling me that? Am I giving you bad information here on the show? I try not to. Oh.
Your bet of the night is?
I'm taking Villanova. I'm giving Michigan 5. And I'm doing it all day. Hey, John's next. Have a great afternoon, everybody. I certainly hope that you do. Have a wonderful afternoon. Bye-bye.
The Ride with JMV.
Gus Bradley, who is the new defensive coordinator of the Colts.
I think as a defensive coordinator, you're always looking at that fourth quarter rush and how important it is. It wins games for you. It starts up front with our defensive line, and then we build around that. And those cover corners, especially in our style of play, I mean, we're going to be aggressive on the perimeter. You see a lot of press coverage. You know, we've got to win, you know, at the line of scrimmage.